This is the 10th time in NHL history that a Stanley Cup final has gone to seven games. The home team has won seven. The away team has won two. The last time it went to seven games was 1987 when the Edmonton Oilers blew a 3-1 lead in the series and won game seven over the Philadelphia Flyers. One lineup change for the Rangers tonight. Joey Koser cannot go. He's got a leg injury. Nick Kiprios will replace him in the lineup. He's played a couple of games earlier in the playoffs against the Islanders when Koser was injured. The chant of "We want the cup" going up from the crowd here at Madison Square Garden. We are set for the Canadian and American national anthems.
To get focused. It looks like he is. You can see him concentrate and prepare. As we've said many times in this series, the only time he ever gets upset about anything is when he plays a bad game of golf.
Mike Richter, ready to go. Each goaltender has played every game for their respective team, trying to win number 16 and the championship game. Terry Gregson is the referee tonight. This is his 12th playoff game. It is the second, seventh game he's had. He had game seven, San Jose and Toronto in round number two. And it is the third game he has had in this series. The Rangers are 3-1 in games he's officiated. Vancouver is 2-1.
And remember this, Vancouver has scored first in four consecutive games, the last four games in this series. The Rangers have not scored a first period goal in their last three games. Remember, the last time they were here, they had one nullified on the offside call that should have been allowed. However, it's a one-game shot. The fans are standing already and ready. Everybody wants it. Let's watch Mark Messier's first shift.
Messier, Graves, Anderson, Leach, Chinbukaboom for the Rangers. McIntyre, Antoski, Hunter, Hedekin, and Brown. Shot fake by Anderson. Takes the shot, deflected, stopped by McClain, clears it aside. Anderson swings it around, past Messier, Antoski, and Bukaboom go for it and collide. The puck out of the zone to Leach. Leach lifts back in. Brown drives it around the boards. Picked up by Antoski. Antoski for McIntyre. It was deflected. Bukaboom reaches out to get it. Bukaboom fires ahead, intended for Graves. All the way down. Comes to McClain. He plays it away for Messier. Up the board, Steve Larmer has come on for the Rangers with Stefan Matteau.
And right away, Vancouver puts Murray Craven with Pavel Bure. He wants to feed Bure as much as possible.
Richter with a quick shot testing him. Kovalov has come on with Larmer and Matteau, low and Zubov. Moved out of the zone, sent back in by Dave Babich. Babich on with Gerald Dittick. Craven, Bure, and Adams on for Vancouver. The rolling puck into the corner. Larmer is there, checked by Babich. Battle in front as Matteau is battling with Dittick. Lowe is in deep against Murray Craven. Puck along the board. Zuboff in deep to get it. His pass intercepted by Adams. Out comes Bure. Bure on the rush, 3-on-2. He goes down, the pass by Dittick is blocked. Bure
offside.
Gets up. It's an offside whistle.
Bad play by Zuboff as things heat up immediately. Zuboff pinched nicely, got control of the puck, but when he threw a blind pass, it trapped all the Rangers and gave Vancouver a 3-on-2. There comes Zuboff. Look at this bad pass. He's hit. Everybody's trapped deep, and Vancouver has a 3-on-2. And Pavel Bure is forced right there and put offside. Nice play by Alexei Kovalov to stop Vancouver's 3-on-2. Look at Kovalov standing up. Boom! And Bure's offside, and the Rangers get a break. You can't throw the puck blind when you're pinching, you're one of the last players, and Zuboff can't do that.
Nemchinov on with Gilbert and Kiprios, Wells and Lidster, Trevor Linden with Nathan Lafayette and Jeff Courtnall, defense pairing of Ryan Glynn and Jirke Lume. Lume has the puck. Deflects into the Vancouver bench. We've played a minute, 48 seconds of game seven. There's Alexei Kovalov, who made the play on Bure, forcing the offside. Rangers line up with one change. Nick Kiprios is in. Joey Koser is out. Defense pairing. Doug Lidster remains in the lineup. And of course, Mike Richter starting in goal with Glenn Healy as the backup for Mike Keenan. His fourth Stanley Cup final, looking for his first Stanley Cup championship.
He wants his team to forecheck more, do what they call cycling. In other words, turning like a bicycle cycle in the corner. Two or three players to catch Vancouver napping a little bit. And if you get caught deep, interfere with the Vancouver's defensemen so they can't head back up ice offensively.
Thinking and battling in the corner against Lume. McTavish is in. Noonan is in for the puck. He takes a hit from Glynn. Cliff Ronning has it. It's Ronning with Momesso and Jelena. Ryan Glynn moves the puck off the glass, knocked down by Lidster, sends it back into the Vancouver zone. McClain leaves it for Lume. Forechecking is Tikkanen, off his stick, up the boards. McTavish gets it to Tikkanen, trying to put it in front of his block. Noonan looking for it, up the boards, comes Martin Jelena. He slowed down.
Vancouver with too many men for a moment, but the defenseman got on. Rangers are forechecking, but not getting anything out of it yet.
Puck in the Rangers zone, taken away by Brian Noonan. Tikkanen comes out with Jay Wells in the middle. Messier has just come on. Save made by McClain, knocks it into the corner. Brown chops at it. Bounces down in center ice, and Glenn Anderson handles it. Anderson sends back in. Messier for the puck against Hedekin. Messier trying to come out in front. Back pass intended for Graves was wide of the mark and out of the zone.
No fooling around with the Rangers. They're dumping the puck all the time. Not getting caught in the neutral zone. trying to dump as much as possible and work Vancouver's defenseman.
Linden fell down, gets the pass ahead. It's off the stick of Courtnall, and Bukaboom takes over. Messier finished the check on Linden. Graves gets to the puck. Graves lets it clear. Nathan Lafayette has it back. Gave it up to Jeff Bukaboom. 3.5 minutes gone by in the first period. Again, the fans roar at what looked like too many men on the ice. Tipped away and out of the zone. Dittick battling for the puck. Messier's got it. Feeds Larmer. Knocked away from him. Leach picks it up. Rangers with two shots on goal. Canucks with one. Bukaboom holds back. Goes to Larmer. Kovalov has come on with Mantola and Larmer. Larmer was knocked down. And the whistle stops play for a faceoff in the Rangers zone. 16:08 to go. First period, game seven. We'll be right back.
You're not supposed to have six skaters on the ice, and if you count them from right to left, there's six out there. Plus the goaltender, seven. There's no doubt Vancouver has made two sloppy changes. And on that one, in my opinion, they definitely got away with too many men.
Kevin Collins and Ray Scapinello are the linesmen for tonight's game. Messier back on with Graves and Anderson. Messier will go against Murray Craven. Craven on with Adams and Bure. Battle for the puck, sent toward the net. Block. Craven trying to find it. Leach tied him up. Messier's got it.
Craven has had Vancouver's only shot on goal. You'd rather have him shoot the puck than Bure. His job, though, is when he gets the puck, he'll try to pass it to Bure as quickly as possible.
Bure hounded by Leach in deep. Graves moves it around and Messier chases. Bumps with Babbage. Craven and Graves are in after the puck. Bure flies it loose. Slides it ahead for Adams. Adams looking for Dittick. Plays it down the boards into the corner. Dittick against Leach. Leach takes it. Graves comes in to help out. Up for Messier. Past Anderson. And Brian Flynn has the puck. Careful start thus far, John.
Well, I think the Rangers tried to forecheck early, got nothing out of it. Vancouver has gotten through that first squall. Now it's their turn to try and get smart. Now both teams, it appears, have to play a bright game defensively, not give up anything.
Offside was whistled against Vancouver. Almost 5 minutes in. 4:52 gone by. As you look at Brian Flynn, boy, has he come a long way. A man picked up on waivers from Ottawa and got a chance to play when Dana Merson got hurt early in the playoffs, and he's taken advantage of it.
Well, Vancouver yesterday, actually Sunday, had 14 players go into that hyperbaric chamber. They went in 1 hour and 15 minutes apiece to inhale the pure oxygen. They have two machines in Vancouver, one at the University of British Columbia and the other in the Canuck dressing room. So they took advantage of that during the 2 days off prior to this game.
Deakin and knocked away by Lume. Ronning avoids the hit of McTavish. Richter leaves the puck to Doug Lidster. Mavesso is after him. Lidster moves it around the boards. Deakin lifts it clear. Knocked down by Lume. Cliff Ronning has it and sends it back in.
But for two or three shifts now, Vancouver has controlled the neutral zone, and they too are dumping the puck in a lot.
Jeff Brown
is another example of it. Neutral zone is where Brown got the puck, and he dumped it in deep.
Rangers have not scored a first period goal in the last three games. Dangerous play, saved by Richter, and it's knocked loose. Noonan's got it. It bounced down, and they got a shot on Richter, and he made the stop. Brown back to the puck. And you can almost hear the nervous reaction from the fans coming up. A couple of good hits by the Rangers, one by Nemchinov. The puck all the way down. This will be an icing. Low for the touch. Fans like it.
Greg Gilbert did a nice job stopping Big Tim Hunter from hitting Kevin Lowe as he got to the puck first for the icing. See lots of hitting, very few scoring chances. Watch where the puck goes. It went up through the middle. Now it drops down in front of Doug Lidster, who was put in a very awkward position by Jay Wells. And Mike Richter made a nice save. And that was the big boys on the ice, Antoski and Hunter, who had the scoring chance. You can't go through the middle like that. You want to bank the puck off the board, so Jay Wells will know that for his next shift.
Kovalov against Linden for the faceoff. Hits are even thus far. Canucks away with the puck. Brett Hedekin. Boy, has he had a great series. Good rush. Zubov picks him up. Takes the puck away. Off the board for Kovalov. Missed it. Brown goes for it. Little quick from Courtnall helps him get free. On the boards. Lafayette kicks it clear. Marver sends it back. Kovalov couldn't play it. Zubov has it. Courtnall on him. Kovalov takes the puck. Courtnall with the hit on Zubov. A giveaway. Hedekin turns. Plays it down the boards. Zubov goes to get it. Swings it around. Marver for Kovalov. Kovalov moving. Kovalov in against Brown. He looks. He shoots. Wide. Around the boards. Marver keeps it in.
3-on-3. Kovalov had no choice but to shoot.
Kovalov tries again, but fanned on it. Bounces down. The shot went wide by Matteau. Lafayette takes over. Off for Courtnall. He's hit high and hard by Bukaboom. They both went down, and they're both slow to get up. The whistle stops play. Bukaboom is still down.
Boy, did he take a run at Courtnall, and this stick is stuck in the back of his jersey. He's been hit up high. Courtnall's grabbing his throat. Bukaboom was the aggressor. I don't think there's any penalties to be handed out here. Matteau just missed the open net. Matteau's only had one shot on goal in his last four games. He needs offense. I think Bukaboom got hit in the throat. As he moves in, look at the stick. Right there, catches Bukaboom across the side of the face as Courtnall put the stick up to protect himself as big Bukaboom comes across. Boom! Oh my.
So that's Courtnall's stick that's stuck up in his jersey.
I don't think there's a penalty to be handed out. That was a heck of a collision with Bukaboom, the biggest Ranger defenseman, hitting Courtnall, who's been on fire with four goals in the last two games. Matteau needs shots. He's been involved. He's been taking the body a little bit. Puck lands, he chops at it, but it zings just wide. Again, he's only had one shot on goal in the last four games, and he's criticized himself for not being in position to get the shots. Well, on that play, he was in position and just missed.
Matteau works on the stick. A little over 7 minutes gone by in the first period. There's no score in the game.
So far, Terry Gregson, the referee, not calling any cheap penalties, and I like that.
Jay Wells with the puck. McIntyre lost the stick around the boards. Tied up. Hunter going for it. List replacing. Off of Levchinov's stick out of the zone. Dumped in by Kiprios. McLean stops it. Around the glass. Bounces down. Lidstrom missed it. Wells has to go get it. John McIntyre bearing down on him. Long pass to Gilbert. Back to the other side. The race is on for the puck. Gilbert did not get to the red line. Icing his whistle. Kiprios was after the puck.
Kiprios said that if he played, he'd like to get some hits early. And on this shift, he threw one into Antoski along the far boards. Antoski, the biggest player, 240 pounds in the series. But it's easy to say that when you haven't played for quite a few weeks and you know how hot it is here. By the way, the Madison Square Garden people had the air conditioning on all night long to try and keep it cool in here to help the ice be good for the game.
Former Rangers, Mark Hislip, Dave Maloney, Frank Beaton, Wolf Nielsen. In the front row, the big whistle, Bill Chadwick, Mike McEwen next to him. A little farther down, Mike Backman, Ron Duguay is here, and Johnny Mack wearing the Rangers cap. Ryan Leach with the puck, no score of the game, 12:15 to go, first period, a giveaway. Adams sends it back, gave it up to Bukaboom. Leach, still checking his foray. Here's Graves on the move. Dumps to the corner. Adams gets there. Anderson gets there on him. Moved up the boards. Bukaboom stops it. Graves. Messier in the corner. Checked by Adams. Messier keeps moving. Fire. Stopped by McLean. Lume chopped that by Anderson. Craven's got the puck. Bure goes wide to the right side. Craven carries. Bure trailing. Craven for Bure. Stopped by Richter. Trying to gain control. One hands it around the boards. Bukaboom tries to clear and does. Jeff Brown after it. Messier got tripped up as he was tangled up with Fred Hedekin. Bure looking for some space. Lomesso for Ronning. Ronning against Lowe. Ronning moves back, plays it down the board to Lomesso. Lomesso picked up by McTavish. Now it's Bure who has stayed on. Long shift for him, intercepted by Tekin, and he waits, sends it out to Kevin Lowe. Avoids Bure. Canucks send it back in. McTavish bumps with Lomesso all the way in. Richter waits. Lomesso tries to take it. Oh, he's strong. Ronning is in there. Zubov works it loose. Just under 11 minutes to go in the first period with no score in the game. The game for the Stanley Cup Championship. Dave Babbage back for it. Rangers have four shots on goal, Canucks three.
I don't think there's been a good one though, Sam. Not a quality scoring chance yet.
As long the two teams
have really had to work for their scoring chances so far.
Wells just dumps it out. Sliding all the way down, it'll be an icing if Didick gets there first, and he does. Play stops with 10:32 to go in the first period. No score in the game. You can now order a souvenir copy of the Rangers Stanley Cup Finals program for only $7 plus $2.95 for shipping and handling. You order call 1-800-769-8843.
Rangers have iced the puck. They're not taking any chances. That puts pressure on faceoffs. And Kovalov just won one against Trevor Linden.
Ryan Flynn has the puck. Now Jurki Lume. Rangers have Kovalov, Larmer, and Mattel on the ice. Kovalov sliding across. Bounces down the Larmer. He turns and he shoots off the glove of McLean. Bounces in the corner.
Now that's the best shot the Rangers have had as the puck goes into the stands along the corner. Steve Larmer was maybe the most open a Ranger forward's been so far in the first period. We're nearing the midpoint of the period. And he's got a good shot, even from bad angles. He went high to the glove side. And Kirk McLean made the save. There you see how much room he's got. And a good shot because it was back against the grain. He was going to his left, shoots a puck back to his right. And that'll sometimes fool a goaltender, but not Kirk McLean. By the way, Kirk McLean is making his 49th consecutive start in the playoffs for Vancouver, and Pat Quinn has coached every one of them.
Brown pressed by Gilbert, moves it around the boards to Hedekin. Canucks move out. Cortnall with Linden and Lafayette. Leach after the puck, gets there. Leach starts to move. Linden slows it down. Leach fires out. Back the other way. Lafayette had to wait for his teammate to get onside, but Jeff Cortnall couldn't do it. Whistle stops play, 9:46 remaining in the first period of a scoreless game. And remember, when you're having good times with friends, use good sense and drink responsibly, please. Know when to say when. Reminder from Budweiser.
Rangers are pressing, Vancouver's pressing. The Rangers, in my opinion, have had the one good shot, that was by Larmer. And I don't think Vancouver, aside from the one scramble when Antoski and Hunter were in front, have had themselves a quality scoring chance. So these two teams are trying to play smart defensively and maybe force the other team into some kind of a mistake.
John McIntyre started the year with the New York Rangers. Picked up by the Vancouver Canucks. Fired in. Leach takes a hit from McIntyre. Graves battling along the board, trying to dig it loose. McIntyre and Leach in the corner. Hunter against Graves.
And Toski and Leach. A McIntyre and Leach, pardon me.
Graves, chopped at by Hunter. Anderson knocked down by Hedekin. Messier moving in, and Koski's got the puck. Around the boards for Hunter, and he's hit by Bukaboom. The puck slides into the Rangers' zone, and Leach gets there.
Bukaboom has come back and played hard, taking the body since he was injured on a hit with Cortnall.
Messier slowed down by Bure, gets by him. Messier cuts in, still with the puck. Nice pass to Zubov. Zubov feeds Leach. Leach scores! A brilliant passing play by Messier, Zubov with Leach finishing. The Rangers lead 1-0.
Now that's hockey. Mark Messier, you'll see, get control of the puck and power through Bure right there. Now when he gains the zone, he's got to make the smart play. Watch Leach take his time to hit the open net, which he does. Messier's a magnet. When he draws people to him, others are open. Beautiful play by the big boys for the Rangers. Messier with power. Now watch him draw people to him and pass the puck with authority. Now Zubov has his defense partner in on the play, and bingo, it's 1-0.
Zubov and Leach, they were the keys to giving the Rangers the big lead in the series. They combine. Shot by Graven goes wide, bounces down. Larmer back for the puck. Bure is after it.
Vancouver has come back quickly to score in this series after the Rangers have.
Babich is open. The shot was knocked down. Kovalov has got it in the jersey. And play stops. Leach gets the goal. His 11th of the playoffs from Zubov and Messier at 11:02. Messier has scored in 21 of the 23 Ranger games in the playoffs. Ryan Leach has only been shut out in four games in the playoffs, and he ties Dennis Potvin and Al MacInnis for most goals by a defenseman in the Stanley Cup Final.
Now the Avalanche of support in Madison Square Garden goes towards the New York Rangers from their fans. Look at Messier draw two people. Now you see the pick by Graves, Adam, and you see Leach wide open, and he took his time to make sure of his shot. Alexei Kovalov has been good defensively.
Lynn down low off the stick of Linden and knocked away by Richter. Around the net, Wells chasing. Wells fires it out of the zone. All the way down on goal, Kirk McLean has to play it. Off the boards, Larmer bumps Horton all the time in the zone, sent back in by Lidstrom. 8-10 to go in the first, and the Rangers have the first goal of the game for the first time since game two. Linden dumps in off the corner board. Courtnall gets there. Shot knocked down by Richter. What a play by Courtnall, hustling for the puck with Lidstrom on him.
Courtnall's a great shooter, and he loves to shoot more so than pass. Now, Vancouver, Sam, they always seem to show that they have the ability to come back right away. They have not backed up since the Rangers scored the goal.
Not at all. Graves gets out of the zone, slowed down by Jelena. Messier chases after it. Messier's got it. Graves trying to get loose in front, was tangled up with his own man, Glenn Anderson, to puck up the board. And out comes Jelena. Across to Mameso. Mameso against Bukaboom and Graves. Jelena's got the puck. Bukaboom staying with Mameso. Anderson against Ronning. Ronning with a back pass. Brown played it across. Jelena tied up with Anderson. Messier goes over to help out. His pass off the skate. Rangers trying to work it out of the zone. Finally do.
But Anderson got hurt on the play. He's down. And now there's a stoppage because of the injury. And you can see he's been cut. I don't know what happened. The players wanted Mameso. Mameso's been a mean, big, tough player in this series. And it looks like with the way the Rangers are going after him, he may be the person involved with the Anderson play. Mameso has done his job. Absolutely. And his job is to use his size and to play as tough as possible. And believe me, he's big. 215, 6'3". Jelena and Anderson battle. Messier's in there. Now, the puck just misses, and there's the stick by Mameso as he went into Messier. Anderson was already down on his knees. Boy, Mameso was looking to his left. That's where Anderson's face was.
I don't know if it was intentional.
I know.
Because Mameso was going to
Messier. He went into Messier, right. Yeah.
We'll step out for a moment. 7:01 to go, first period. Rangers are leading. Ranger medical team checking in on Glenn Anderson.
Dr. Nissenson looking on with David Smith. The referee's job is to keep the players in the game whenever possible. And if they did not think it was done on purpose, or if they didn't see it, that's the way it goes. It has to be conclusive and it has to be intentional. And I don't think it was. As Mameso went into Messier, Anderson was already down on his knees. And did he ever take the stick across the face?
Bukaboom sends it down the ice.
It's highly important for the Rangers, too, not to get carried away with Mameso and take a penalty.
Icing. Good effort by McTavish. Tied up Babbage originally, but the third man actually down the ice was the Vancouver Canuck to make the touch for icing. 6:48 to go in the first period. Rangers leading 1-0 on a goal by Brian Leach at 11:02.
Shots are 7-6 in favor of the Rangers. There's only the one odd man rush by Vancouver, and that was very early in the period when Kovalov forced the offside. Glenn Anderson's nose is obviously broken. It's been cut. It's bleeding quite badly. But in this situation, you don't go to the locker room unless it's the end of the period. You try and get it closed up. You'll see there where David Smith is shoving the packing up the nose itself to stop the bleeding so he can get back on the ice.
Hard to breathe with the packing.
Now you breathe through your mouth. There's no problem. It's hockey.
Noonan for Leach. He's tied up by Lume. Big crowd in the crease as Lafayette's tying up Tikkanen. McTavish battling Lume. Puck kicked free. Noonan gets there. McTavish against Lume in the corner. It's loose again. Noonan's got it. He's checked there by Glenn. Noonan moves it. McTavish tied up with Lume. Tikkanen working. Can't get out in front.
What the Rangers want if this is their game plan. Dump the puck and cycle and work the Vancouver defense. Try and draw a penalty, but don't get three forwards caught deep across the goal line, in behind the goal net.
Bukaboom's there to stop it. McTavish, penalty upcoming. The Rangers working so hard, drew a penalty on the Canucks. first power play of the game to the Rangers.
That's a great shift. Absolutely great. That's exactly what the Rangers talked about. Sam, on the way back from Vancouver, the Rangers on the aircraft looked at video of fundamental mistakes, what they weren't doing. And this was one of them. And it was a good ploy by the Rangers to set this up and have the players understand what was missing. Hard work was one of them. And there you see McTavish drive a penalty when Lume did not have a stick.
Let's see what Yurke Lume thought of the call.
Taking it. You got to work to win games like this. It's one-on-one battles all over the ice surface, and if you can work the other team deep and continue to control the puck. Remember, Jeff Bukaboom pinched and kept the puck alive. You'll see it right there. The play is still alive. Now McTavish can go after the puck. Broken stick and a penalty. And the Rangers power play goes to work.
Lume for cross-checking at 14:03. And the Rangers have the first power play of the game. They are 4-for-25 on the power play in the series, with Kovalov having 3 of the 4, Zubov the other one.
Vancouver does not have a shorthanded goal, but always watch Pavel Bure.
Leach takes the shot, save, rebound, and Messier was tied up trying to draw a penalty. Here's Kovalov shooting, and a save by McClain. Bure to the puck. Bure was hit by Messier, Kovalov keeps it in. Nice pass to Graves, he's checked, and Brown fires it all the way down.
That initial shot from the point was deflected by Messier, and McClain made a great save.
Bure all over Leach. Good pressure. Zubov has the puck. Bure and Craven, Brown and Hedekin for Vancouver. Zubov and Leach, Messier, Graves, and Kovalov for the Rangers. Kovalov to the puck. Now Graves, he scores! Oh. Adam Graves! It's a power play goal! And the Rangers lead 2-0. They needed him.
Look who's on the puck. Vancouver stands up. Kovalov stays wide. And Adam Graves with a beautiful shot. All series long, he shot to the catching glove side. This time he said he's going to space his shots out. He goes to the stick side. What a pass. What a shot. Power play goal for the Rangers. And they're having a great time here celebrating in Madison Square Garden. Vancouver tried to stand up, Kovalov stayed wide. Oh my, did the Rangers make it look nice with some great skill play.
Adam Graves has gone 10 games without a goal. The man who led the Rangers in goal scoring in the regular season with 52, setting a team record, breaks loose for his first goal of this series. His 10th of the playoffs from Kovalov and Zubov at 14:45.
Again, after a goal, you can't sit and celebrate because the other team will get one right back. That's how good they are. You have to remain focused.
Graves to Messier and around the boards. Graves after. Kovalov remains on with Messier and Graves after a strong power play shift. Back pass to Bukaboom toward the net. Save McClain. He holds it with a glove as Messier causing some distraction with a stick.
Yesterday, Adam Graves said it was the first time in 10 days that he's been able to relax. And there's no doubt in my mind that the additional day between Game 6 and Game 7 was one the Rangers took advantage of. People like Brian Leach said he relaxed. Adam Graves relaxed. Look at this. This is a power play goal off a rush. Vancouver stands up, Zubov goes down, but gets the puck through. Now looking over on the other side, Messier was there in case of a rebound. Beautiful shot by Graves, the power play works. That's the fourth game of the series the Rangers have had a power play goal. This one's the biggest.
We talked about Leach being a factor in the games in which the Rangers lost. Zubov's absence, he had had only 5 shots in the last 3 games. They have been all over him and cut him down. He has 2 assists in this game thus far.
Vancouver's dumped the puck a lot, but they haven't done a lot with it. There they try it again, see?
Giveaway, kept in by Courtnall, blocked in front by Lowe. He got tripped up, but he covers the puck and gets a whistle to stop play.
You know where the puck was. You see the Rangers on every stoppage, they're not backing up. Vancouver's trying to press here. They are a very good hockey club, but the Rangers are playing with a with an air of confidence. And every stoppage there, you saw the Rangers move over the Tavis, push Linden. They're on their home turf, and they're trying to take advantage of it.
And it's not only confidence, John. It's an air of determination also. You can see it in every chip. Mark Messier. Game 7, 9 times. 4 goals, 7 assists, 11 points when he's played in his 7th game. Lukaboom has the puck. 4:25 to go in the first period. The Rangers have outshot the Canucks 11-6 and lead 2-0. McTavish hooking his way by Glenn. Noonan in after the puck. He's tied up with Linden. Noonan along the boards to pass across, goes by Tinkin, and Bukaboom's got it toward the net. Sticked aside by McClain. Got that cleared by Lume.
Tavish having a big first period for the Rangers. He slingshotted past Glenn to negate the icing, and the Rangers had a shot on goal.
Tinkin wraps up Lume up with the puck. Moves off the boards with Brian Glenn. Back to get it is Jay Wells. Down in the zone. Canucks go over to player. Jeff Brown across to Brett Hennepin. And the crowd alive. Something the Rangers needed badly. They've gotten the crowd into the game immediately. Icing is whistled and a standing ovation for the Rangers.
They're enjoying the first period, but remember, it's only the first period. That's McNabb, a true gentleman who works with the New Jersey Devils, came up with a nugget. He said there's never been a Stanley Cup team win a championship with a captain that's been traded for. Rangers have one. That's the best thing that's happened to this franchise and maybe ever. It's Mark Messier. He's a Ranger now, and he's got his team on a roll with a great first period.
This could be the crowning jewel of his career, John, if he can... If the Rangers come through tonight.
A long way to go. The Rangers want to keep dumping the puck deep, keep working Vancouver, and when you do that, you eliminate Vancouver's defense from joining the rush up ice.
Komolov goes forward with a face-off, the shot deflected wide. Good play by Komolov. Zubov comes over, Mameso reaching out after him.
I'll tell you what Matteau did, he just pulled the net off. He was trapped in behind the goal. He's lucky he didn't get caught. It would have been a penalty for delay of game.
Play continuing, they finally blow the whistle.
Matteau was stuck in behind Kirk McLean's net. The goaltender, is telling the linesman, Matteau, and Matteau wasn't very good at it. It took him about 4 pushes and stubs to pull the net off the mooring to try and get play stopped because he was caught up ice. And he's very lucky that the referee didn't see. The linesman can't call it. It's a minor unless there's too many men on the ice. He can't call this delay of game. But the referee, if he would have seen it, it would have been a penalty for Matteau for delay of game.
3:17 to go in the first period. Rangers with a 2-0 lead. Stefan Matteau has not scored a goal since scoring the series winner in Game 7 against the New Jersey Devils. This is the third time. Well, the linesman steps in between Mameso and Noonan.
And who is it? Again, Vic Sergio, who's played a great series. He's been belligerent. He's been mean. And the Rangers are trying to take him and negate that stuff.
This is the third Game 7. Ever played here at Madison Square Garden, and the Rangers have won the previous two, both against the New Jersey Devils. Nikitin picking up the loose puck. He's tied up. Pass off the skate of Jelena. Mameso grabs hold of Noonan and pulled him down. That prompted the roar.
Yeah, he got away with one there, no doubt about that.
Off the skate of Jelena. He's hip-checked by Leach. And a penalty is upcoming. Is this a penalty?
No, I believe it's offside.
Okay. I thought I saw Drayton's arm go up.
When Jelena was hit, he jumped up to try to avoid the hit. Mameso reached out and caught Noonan up high. And the Rangers are trying to get Mameso off his game so he doesn't destroy Brian Leach. Look at this. It's a good cross check across the shoulder. Terry Gregson lets that go. More of a shove than a cross check. He had one hand on the stick.
Yeah.
When you see that, good look at it. Look, Jelena jump. Boom! Oh my, we're seeing some good hitting. Both clubs involved. See Jelena try to turn and avoid the hit. Brian Leach came across with a good hit.
Messier back on with Glenn Anderson returning for the first time since he took the stick in the face from Mameso. Puck is knocked down by Babich. Babich and Babich. Anderson jabbing one another with the stick.
Again, you're seeing the Rangers try to play a belligerent game on their home ice. Babich had the puck stuck in his equipment. Anderson gave him a shot. So Babich gave him a shot back and Messier was over. The Rangers are just trying to play a very intense, team game that they've been known for all season long.
Controlled aggression.
That's it. They've outshot Vancouver 12-6. Remember, the shots were 7-6 about 5 minutes ago. The next goal is so important, and the next power play might be very important. Vancouver's got no offense yet.
Giveaway, Adams turns and shoots, and it went wide. It went through with Richter, but just wide of the net. Bourre gets away from Messier. Bourre around the net. Bourre turns. Bourre looking for the shot, and he can't get it to the net. It rolled right through the crease. What a move by Bourre. Did everything but put it in the net. Another shot is a save by Richter, and it's cleared by Messier. What a fantastic move by Pavel Bourre.
Not a player in the league that can find a way to get the shot on goal any better than Bourre. It looks like he's got nothing, and he'll make something out of it. And Sam, not only on the forehand, but also on the backhand.
Up behind the net, taken away by the Canucks. Out of the zone from Sean Antoski, trying to get it to Hunter, playing down the boards. Hunter gets low, low chops at him. Dubov hit by Hunter, and the whistle stops play.
Well, a good interference by Mantle, who's working in this one. Antoski, he's like a missile. He wants to seek a Ranger and destroy the player deep in the player's zone. But he couldn't get through. Mantle held him up. Greg Adams shot. I thought it was in. Look at that. Oh, just wide of the goalpost. Craven had his hands up. Now it's showtime for Pavel Bourre, who shows he can take a hit twice there. And watch this. You look like he's got nothing to do. Nowhere to shoot the puck, but watch him go and find something. He's got everybody reaching. And he's finally hooked in the last second, and the puck just grazes wide. A little hook by Brian Leach stopped the good shot with the open net, and then Jeff Bukenboom helped out. Pavel Bourre, you can see exactly his frustration. His first 50 goals he scored this year, 33 were on the road. He doesn't get intimidated.
1:36 to go. In the first period, the Rangers holding a 2-0 lead. Hedekin takes the puck. Nice pass to Linden. Lafayette to his right. Linden carries across and dumps in. Richter puts it in the corner. McTavish with Courtnall on him. Almost given up to Lafayette. Rangers pack it ahead. Taking it out to Noonan. Noonan across against Jeff Brown. Toward the net. And it almost was batted in. It almost went in off McTavish. Went off the stick of McLean. Then McTavish heading for the net. Had it go off him, but just wide. And then the net was knocked off.
Taking it and Hedekin getting a one another. McTavish drove to the net. The Rangers came out of their zone nicely after Mike Richter had some trouble giving McTavish the puck with a handoff back in the Rangers zone. And up ice they come. Noonan to the net. Look who's driving to the net. And he's upended. That's McTavish by Hedekin. And Kirk McLean with just a little extra. Well, you don't have a helmet, cover your head. Good little play by the goaltender, sticking the puck aside. And you love to drive to the net away from the puck in case it comes to you. Good a stick play. Good play. And there's McTavish. Good play. McTavish has had a good period, not only deep in the Vancouver zone, but also winning draws.
Brett Hedekin. And Essentikinen will sit for 2 minutes. And it'll be 4-on-4 action with 1:10 remaining in the first period.
I wonder if Pat Quinn, in this situation, is the coach of a team down 2-0, puts Pavel Bourre on the ice to go for it, or does he wonder about the Rangers, because Messier, I think, is fresh and Leach is fresh. If they go for it and they get beat for a goal, it's 3-0. He'd try and play defensive here to end the period, get out of it down by two.
What would you do, coach?
Oh, I know what I'd do if I was a Rangers coach. I have those guys on the ice. Are you lucky? Leach, Messier, Graves, and Bukaboo, and Pavel Bourre sitting on the bench.
Deacon and Hedekin 2 minutes each for roughing. Messier with Graves, Bukaboo, and Leach for the Rangers. Linden and Courtnall, Lume and Glenn for Vancouver. Linden wins the faceoff. Lume chases. Puck cleared up into the crowd. Following the conclusion of the first period, Al Trotwig will talk to two members of the Hockey Hall of Fame, the keepers of the cup. The cup, which is here under safekeeping and awaiting. There's Mayor Rudolph Giuliani in attendance with his son Andrew. And then Bob Page will have an update at the MSG Sports Desk. JD and I will have first period highlights. Hope you'll stay with us. with just under 1 minute to go in the first period. The Rangers leading 2-0. Messier won the faceoff. The puck in the corner, Cortnall goes back to get it. Shots are 12-9 in favor of the Rangers. Trevor Linden moving with the puck, Cortnall trailing him. Richter goes out to get it. Messier plays it, back the other way to Bukovic.
Another play, even if it's 4-on-4, the Rangers force Linden into dumping the puck. Here's a pass that goes astray, and it's now icing with 34.2 seconds to go, and a very important draw in the Rangers' zone. Now Vancouver, remember, they have to put the players on the ice first, and the Rangers have the option of then making the change or the matchup they want. That's the advantage of home ice. Pat Quinn has put Pavel Bure on the ice now, and the Rangers take Bukovic off, put Zubov on the ice. Zubov and Leach, when they've been on the ice against Bure in the series, have had success against them. They seem to think alike what they want to do with the puck and when they're defending the man with the puck.
Messier against Craven. Craven, Bure, Brown, and Babich for Vancouver. Messier and Zubov get together.
Brian Leach skated over to Mike Keenan to get instructions as to what to do on the alignment for the faceoff. See, Messier's left hand is turned over. That means he's drawing the puck possibly back in that direction.
Leach tells Graves something, possibly that he's going to cover it. No, Graves is going to Bure. Shot from the point goes wide. Around the boards, Bure is there and he's hit by Messier. Messier is bumped by Craven. Leach looking for the puck. Messier's got it. Rangers break out. 3-on-2. Messier across. Dropped to Graves. Taken away by Craven. Clears the zone. Off the stick of Leach. And Richter goes out to play it away from Bure. Richter holding. Graves has it and lifts it clear. Final seconds of the first period. They're on their feet at Madison Square Garden. The Rangers have a 2-0 lead. One period complete in the game for the Stanley Cup.
Very intense, very hard fought. However, it was the skill level of people like Brian Leach and Mark Messier and Zubov and Graves that gives the Rangers a 2-0 lead.
A good period for the Rangers. Leach and Graves score. Now Trotwick coming up in a moment. Hedekin and Tikkanen and still the penalty boxes for another 49 seconds. Leach and Bukaboom, Messier and Graves for the Rangers, Linden and Cortnall, Babich and Didick for the Canucks.
Wonder if Vancouver will have an initial good spurt here.
Messier with a steal from Didick, rather from Cortnall. Leach in deep with the puck. Back pass to Messier, saved by McClain. Out the other way, Linden. Leach hustling to catch up. He does. Bukaboom to the puck. What did you start to say about Duguay?
Wonder why he looks so good. Actually, both fellas look terrific. The big whistle and Ronnie Duguay.
Great officials of all time, Bill Chadwick, who is up in the broadcast booth. And we say hello to my predecessor and Bill's broadcast partner, Jim Gordon, who's watching at home. Just had shoulder surgery. Shot by Messier and stopped by McClain. Hope you're feeling better, Jim, and hope you're enjoying the Rangers' drive toward the Stanley Cup. Zubov with a long shot that's blocked. Noonan tees it up. Knocked away by Lume. Picked up by Hedekin. The teams are back at full strength. Hedekin weaves his way out of the zone. Slides into the Rangers zone. It'll be an icing. He did not gain the red line. Fans love it. Minute 16 seconds into the second period.
First shift for Pavel Bure in the second period. He had one shot on goal in the first period. That gives him 100 for the playoffs. More than any other player. Adam Graves is second now with 91. And it looked like the Rangers by design had Esa Tikkanen on the ice when Bure was out there. And you look at Brian Leach, he said the day off did him a world of good. He said he felt relaxed. I said, hey, the first two big hits in Vancouver, did that hurt you? And the first period, he said, no, actually woke me up. I needed it. But here he hasn't been hit yet. He has not been hit hard by the Canucks forechecking. The Rangers have been the team forechecking.
And Leach, Zubov, and Messier have been involved and produced. Bukaboom, wrist shot. Save McClain, rebound! It's blocked! Great play by Brian Glynn, sliding across to block what might have been a Tikkanen goal. Shot by Adams, goes wide. Bounces down behind the net. Moved by Leach away from Bure. Craven gets there to keep it in. Leach stops it. Leach out for the puck. dumps into the Vancouver zone. Lume goes back to get it. Lume trying to get it ahead. It was blocked by Tikkanen. The other way goes Brian Glynn. Jurke Lume has the puck. 2 minutes gone by in the second period. Rangers doing an excellent job keeping the puck in. Around the net comes Matteau. He's picked up there. Puck along the boards. Canucks trying to move it clear. Stopped by Zubov. Zubov feeding. That shot by Marmer was blocked. And Bure pulls it out.
So Bure with a long shift again.
Gave it up to Kevin Lowe as he goes to the bench. Rangers go the other way. Larmer lost it. Across the line, Jelena bangs with Zubov. Lowe with Lomesso chopping at him with a stick. In front, knocked aside from running by Kovalov. He's
maybe
off the boards himself.
Maybe the best game I've seen Kovalov play defensively.
He turns. He shoots. Save McClain. Drops it off and bats it into the corner. Canucks go the other way. Hedekin to Ronning. Ronning with Jelena to his right. Gave it up to Kovalov. Clears the zone. Matteau is tied up. He finds the puck. The two-line pass whistled against the Rangers. 2 minutes, 50 seconds gone by in the second period, and the Rangers are holding a 2-0 lead.
We've been talking about Kovalov defensively. There he wrestles down running, and now he'll hustle back in the zone, and watch this. It looks like a Vancouver scoring chance. Who reaches out for the puck but Alexei Kovalov? I've never seen him pay such attention to detail defensively. That's about four good plays through the beginning of the second period and the first period, all told.
It's interesting, John, we talked about Messier, Leach, and Zubov, and talking to associate coach Colin Campbell this morning, he said, we need a big game from Kovalov.
Well, he's gotten one so far.
Loose puck in the corner, Nathan Lafayette to it, blocked by McTavish. Lafayette's pass knocked away by Noonan. Noonan breaks out with Tikkanen. Babich is back. Noonan across, looking for Tikkanen. He shoots, it trickled wide. Just went wide. Babich moves it to the board. Tikkanen gets there. McClain out to play the puck.
This line has been terrific for the Rangers. McTavish, Tikkanen, and Noonan.
Lidstrom couldn't keep it in the zone. Wells goes back to get it. On him is Lafayette. Fires it across. Lume's got it. Rangers have outshot the Canucks 5-0 here early in the second period. Leach takes it back. Backhands it ahead out of the zone. Nice pass. Glenn Anderson. It took three stitches in the nose. Moves in. Anderson gets the shot off. A save by McClain.
Rangers are doing a good job driving to the net. We saw Noonan and Tikkanen team up for a scoring chance. Here, Glenn Anderson, who had his nose stitched up between periods, gets the puck on the backhand side and drives to the net. Here's Noonan. Settles the puck across. There's Tikkanen with a shot. Saved by McClain as the Rangers are driving to the net. Now you'll see the Rangers head up ice again. And this time Glenn Anderson will go one-on-one to the backhand side. He loves playing right wing. He can use his left leg to shield the defenseman's stick and drive to the net. He paid that time as he crashed into the backboards. But that was vintage Glenn Anderson.
Nemchinov on with Gilbert and Kiprios. Played toward the net, stopped by McClain. Backhands it around to Tim Hunter. Hunter is hit, turned over the puck, Leach. He's run into, and a high stick on Gilbert from Hunter. Puck around the boards, and a hit by Bukaboom. Canucks unable to clear as Glynn is tied up with Kiprios. Battle along the boards, Demchinov works it around the other side. Lume goes for it. Penalty, no, I thought a penalty was going to get called. When Hunter knocked down Gilbert.
And Nick Kiprios, it looked like he almost killed himself. He missed the check and went head first into the boards. The Rangers, you sense, really want the third goal.
Lowe looks up. Zubov takes the pass. 4.5 minutes gone by in the second period. Down the boards. Messier was hip-checked by Brown and lost his stick. But there's a penalty coming up. Penalty coming up on the Vancouver Canucks.
Jeff Bukaboom, by the way, is over at the Rangers bench, and he may have injured himself. He tried to pinch on the near boards, and one of the Canucks ducked down, and he may have hurt himself. It looks like a leg injury or something. Messier interfered, as you see, there by Brown, the defenseman. Took a stick away and everything, and Ron Smith has had enough. This will be the second power play for the Rangers. Vancouver is yet to have one in this game. Bukaboom pinched earlier. Now watch the Vancouver player duck. Oh, you can see the legs, both knees buckle. Look at the knees of Bukaboom. Oh, man, the right one may have hyperextended on the play. And Bukaboom could very well have a problem. He is still having attention paid to him on the bench. Kiprios missed the check. Look at this. Oh, man. He got up and was okay. He wears extra big shoulder pads, and they may have helped him on that play.
Antoski was the man who hit Bukaboom. Brown's in the penalty box for interference at 4:38. Rangers' second power play of the game. They're 1-for-1. And 5-for-26 in this series. Zubov controlling. Swings it around the boards. Messier, Graves, and Kovalov with Zubov and Leach for the Rangers. Lume with Glynn, Craven, and Bure. Craven to Bure. Zubov goes over. Bure holding. Forced
penalty.
Back out. Penalty
Brian
upcoming.
Leach. But Bure had the puck. Craven drove to the net, and he drew a penalty. The Rangers want the puck here quickly.
They don't get it. It's going to be a break for Trevor Linden. He moves to the net, and he scores! What an effort by Trevor Linden. He was the man who came on when Kirk McLean went to the bench, the extra skater on the delayed penalty, and the Canucks have scored to cut the Rangers' lead to 2-1.
We have a huge swing here. Remember, Bukaboom may be injured. He now is going to the Rangers' locker room. It's a huge swing in the last minute or so. Bukaboom could have a leg injury. Vancouver, on the delayed penalty to the Rangers, kept control of the puck. And then you're going to see Trevor Linden come off the bench as McLean gets there, and now he reaches for the puck. He reached to the Vancouver side of center ice to make sure it was not offside. And then he scored on a beautiful play, a great shot. We're 2-1, and the Rangers still have the power play.
14:39 remaining in the second period. It's a 2-1 game. Rangers still on the power play, as John mentioned. A minute 10 to go. The penalty to Jeff Brown. Zubov has the puck. Cross comes Kovalov. Graves down the board for Kovalov. Try to put it in front. Slides out to Zubov. Across the Leach with room. Back to Zubov. Takes the shot. Deflected into the corner. Messier to Leach. Across to Zubov. Down the boards, pass Kovalov. Graves ties up Lume behind the net. It's driven up the boards, kept in by Zubov. Kovalov missed it, Hedekin clears it. The Vancouver goal, Trevor Linden, his 11th of the playoffs from Glynn and Bure at 5:21. Craven pulled down Messier, prompting the roar from the crowd. Craven takes the shot, deflects up into the crowd, stopping play. 13:42 to go. You hear the crowd reaction as Messier was spun around and flung down in center ice.
Well, this power play has not looked good for the Rangers. Vancouver has scored the shorthanded goal. There's a definite hold in the neutral zone. And Terry Gregson has to make the decisions, penalties or no penalties. 21 seconds still remaining on the Brown penalty. Bukaboom has not returned from the Rangers locker room. So a real big turn. Big turn. See Kovalov with a helmet off to try and breathe a little easier. It's very hot in this building.
Bore's assist gives him 31 points in the playoffs, two behind Ryan Leach. Make it three behind Leach, who has 34 points. Bore with 31 in the race for the lead in playoff scoring. Leach has it. Leach has the puck. The 2-1 Rangers lead. With 13:35 to go in the second, as Lidstrom fires in. Matko shoots wide. Got it off the heel of his stick. Final seconds of the Rangers' power play. Tikkanen plays it across to Leach. Leach shoots, deflected off the arm of McLean. Bounces down behind the net. Matko off the boards for Tikkanen. Brown is back on. Teams at full strength. Shot by Lidstrom. Save McLean. Craven with a bump on Larmer. Tikkanen trying to keep it in. Larmer wraps up Dinnick. Tikkanen shoots the flex across. Babich after the puck. Lidstrom there. He shot it wide. Tikkanen plays it behind the net. Craven picks it up. 13 minutes to go in the second. Rangers leading 2-1. Game 7. The game for the Stanley Cup championship.
Jack Bukaboom cannot come back. Lidstrom and Wells will get more ice time. Especially Lidstrom on the right side.
McTavish chasing on Brian Glynn. Glynn reverses, but he gave it away to Gilbert. Off the stick of Noonan. Back into the corner, McTavish after it. It's worked up the boards and out of the zone. Kevin Lowe takes over. Lowell plays it across to Gilbert. In the middle of Noonan. Noonan moves in with McTavish. McTavish takes the shot. Save McLean at his feet. Ronning works his way around the net. Ronning circles back. Messier has come on. Jerky Lume moves away with help from a pick by Ronning, but gave up the puck to Kevin Lowe. Ronning stops it again. The bouncer, Richter leads it. A whistle for an offside on Vancouver. 12:01 to go, second period. The Canucks have scored a goal by Trevor Linden. The Rangers' lead is cut to 2-1.
Trevor Linden has given Vancouver their only goal in the game. It's shorthanded with a penalty upcoming to Brian Leetch. He makes a great play. Look at the body language leading into Brian Leetch. Now he chips the puck right over Mike Richter, right through him, actually. That's a great play.
Yeah.
Sensational play by the Vancouver captain. Jeff Bookaboom has not returned, but again, he could be in the locker room having his knee taped up. They could be finding a brace to put on the knee, if that's indeed what it is. Rangers need him back.
Jeff Brown with a long drive that Richter stops. Gilbert has the puck off the stick of Nemchinov. Word, Marv Albert passed this along, that the Vancouver Canucks had a charter for the players' wives. Here's Gilbert moving in. The shot went wide. Kiprios gets to the rebound. That charter is still circling over New York. It hasn't landed yet.
Why?
I don't know. Hedekin moving down with the puck. Brett Hedekin is a plus player in 5 of the 6 games in this series. Leet fires across. Diddick sends it back. 11:10 remaining in the second period. Linden after the puck. Moved around the boards by Richter. Lafayette trying to play it. Nemchinov on him. Kiprios moves in to try and move the puck. Back into the corner, Leetch. Leetch paired with Doug Lidster now. Backhands it to Nemchinov. And he fires in. Dave Babich for Vancouver as the Rangers change. Kortnov. Slowed down by Lowe. The pass across the flex to Linden. He controls. He moves in. A save. A skate save by Richter on a great shot by Trevor Linden. And an icing coming up on the Rangers. Trevor Linden, who's been pretty quiet in this series, really putting on an effort here. Crowd on its feet. And a Let's Go Rangers chant going up. Craven against Messier on the draw. Rangers control. Messier with Graves and Anderson. Leetch and Lidster. Craven with Bure and Adams. Glynn and Lume. Lidster slides it out of the zone. Lume is there off the boards. Leetch picks it up. It's a pick from Lidster. Graves couldn't control. Messier tried to get it. Lidster sends it in. Lume got a piece. Graves with a good hit on the boards. Craven's got the puck. Tipped out by Adams. Leetch hustling back. Gets some direction from Richter. Avoids Bure. They both went down. The puck along the boards. Kept in by Hedekin. Along the boards, Adams trying to get free. He's forced back by Lidster, who takes the puck away. Tipped clear by Anderson. 9.5 minutes to go in the second. Rangers leading 2-1. Adams. Kevin Lowe comes over. Puck bounces down in the penalty box and plays stops with 9:19 to go. Rangers without Jeff Bookaboom for the last couple of minutes.
After game 6, in which the Rangers lost, Esa Tikkanen was one of the first players to try to lighten things up. The Rangers had a team meal right after the game. And they were pretty down with the loss, but Tikkanen, knowing his attitude and his personality, tried right there to spark the players. He's a big game player, he's a great checker. People hate playing against him, in particular, Wayne Gretzky hates playing against Esa Tikkanen, and he'd love one half more of a big game and having a good one.
Davis reached up, trying to knock the puck down, he's got it. Sends it off the boards for Noonan. In the Vancouver zone, McLean looks around, keeps it moving. Yelena and Lowe go for it.
It's been a strong line for the Rangers in this game, and they needed that. Other players to put forth a good effort. McTavish, Noonan, and Tikkanen.
And Messo slides it ahead. Jelena couldn't get there. Lowe trying to clear the zone. It's in deep. Zuboff has it. Trying to get away from Jelena. Able to clear the zone. 8:35 to go in the second. Didick. From Messo. Zuboff is there. Now Kevin Lowe. Whistle for a two-line pass. Rangers having some problems getting in the offensive zone last couple of minutes.
Vancouver, led by their goaltender, had a strong beginning as far as keeping the puck out of their own net. The Rangers really pressed, and they couldn't score. Then, with the shorthanded goal, Vancouver has settled the Rangers' offense down. There was a hit as Momessa was knocked down.
Jeff Kukabum has just emerged from the Rangers locker room and is heading to the bench. Seems to be walking okay. Taken back by Dinick. Chopped at by Kovalov. Dinick sends it ahead. A hit by Wells. A shot was blocked by Lidster. Bounces on goal. Stopped by Richter. Marmer pressured by Lafayette. Moves it around to Lidster. Nice pass to Kovalov. A little behind low. Able to get it out of the zone. Babich forces his way back in, surrounded by Rangers. The other way comes Matteau with Dinick back. Matteau the backhand, wide. Wells gets to the puck, shot it wide of the net. Knocked away from Kovalov by Babbitt. Matteau goes over, gets it to Lidster, takes the shot wide. Around the boards, Wells and Lafayette. Wells takes it away. Deep into the corner. Babbitt puts it up the boards. Lidster pinches. Kovalov has the puck, and the shot goes wide. Rangers have missed the net three times. Matteau. Kovalov takes the shot just wide again. Kovalov taken down by Linden. Kovalov bumped by Dinick and tripped up by Dinick, and a penalty call.
Porto. He picked up and knocked down Jeff Larmer. The Rangers with a great shift. Matteau, Kovalov, and Larmer. Yes, they missed the net three times, but they got the puck back every time. And it didn't work. And then finally, Courtnell and Babbitts ended up hauling people down. And you're right, it is Babbitts, not Courtnell. Watch the Rangers battle to get the puck back. Look at Matteau not quit. Larmer's there. In front is Babbitts. Rangers miss the net, but get the puck back. Kovalov battles. Goes right through Dinick, and there you see Courtnell dropping down with Larmer.
I thought it was Dinick who took the penalty.
I thought it was Courtnell.
It's Babich for tripping at 12:46. In any event, the Rangers have the power play, their third of the game.
It's one of the best games I've seen Alexei Kovalov play as a Ranger, even though he hasn't scored a goal. He is just working. He's thinking. He's giving it everything he's got. He's taking hits to make plays, and he didn't do that in Vancouver.
And that's what the Rangers need. They're to win a championship. Their third power play, they're one for two.
And Vancouver has a shorthanded goal.
Messier played across. Zuboff has it in deep to Noonan. I don't know if that's credited as a shorthanded goal shot. Shot by Graves is a save by McLean because it was 5-on-5 when Linden came on as the extra skater on the delay.
McLean was on the bench.
Yeah, but you had five skaters on.
Doesn't matter.
All right. Yeah. All right.
Rangers had six for the record.
Okay. A hit in the corner. Rangers have Graves, Messier, and Noonan for the power play. Zuboff and Leach. Noonan turns, puts it in front, missed by Graves. Noonan's backhander save, and they score! Messier! It's a power play goal! Messier delivers again.
Just hard work once again. Zuba with the play to the front. Noonan to the front. Messier. And the puck is chipped in behind Kirk McLean. Adam Graves is there. Noonan's there. And I think Noonan will get credit as the defenseman in front put it in his own net. You'll see. Actually, it's McIntyre, the forward. He gets his hand on it, and it goes right through the legs of Kirk McLean. So Brian Noonan may get credit for the goal, The Rangers have drawn two power plays that have led to power play goals because of hard work in behind the goal line, and that was their game plan.
6:15 to go in the second. The Rangers have regained a two-goal lead. Kinkinen with the puck. Messier gets credit for the goal. Marner sets up Kinkinen. His shot deflected by Brown. Adams back for the puck. Adams checked by McTavish. Hennigan has the puck for Vancouver. Rangers have outshot the Canucks 25-15 and lead 3-1, and they have scored two power play goals. Foray was stopped by Leach. Foray knocks the puck down. Leach has the stick in the midsection. Tipped ahead. Richter covers up with Adams there. They're on their feet at Madison Square Garden. There's 5:37 remaining in the second period, and the Rangers lead 3-1. 5:37 to go. They love it at Madison Square Garden. Rangers leading 3-1.
They've not been outworked in this game. Everybody is doing something. Kovalov, Matteau, Larmer, Noonan. Everybody.
McTavish has had a strong game. Tipped ahead. Kinkinen goes back to get it. Kinkinen, McTavish, and Noonan on. Messier got the goal, his 12th of the playoffs, from Graves and Noonan at 13:29. The Rangers with two power play goals. Bemesso threw the elbow into Zuboff. Running with a setup for Jelena just behind him. Jelena left it along the boards. In deep running. Comes out in front. Puck is loose. Knocked aside. Didn't shoot. Save Richter. Zuboff can't clear. Save Richter on running. And another save. And he's got the puck.
Oh, did Sergei Zuboff ever get nailed by Sergio Bemesso? Right up at center ice along the boards. And that game, Vancouver a chance to move in. Watch this hit. Boom! Zuboff didn't know what number the train was. And now Vancouver has a chance to throw the puck at the net. And it's Mike Richter's turn. This save on Ronning was spectacular. Absolutely spectacular. He'll drop down. Watch him stack the pads. Oh my, what a save. As Cliff Ronning was robbed, Vancouver tries everything they can. Started with a big hit by Bemesso, and Mike Richter, oh, doesn't get any better.
Chit chat. What could Alexei Kovalov be telling Mike Richter?
Hey, whatever it is, it's working for Kovalov. He's played brilliantly.
Actually, probably discussed the faceoff. Matteau and Larmer 2-on-1. Saved by McClain. Matteau centers. Puck moved aside. Lidster moves it down the boards. Kovalov in the corner. Lume to the puck. 4.5 minutes to go. Second period. Rangers leading 3-1. Kovalov for Larmer. The end of the Vancouver zone they go. Lume back to get it. Larmer forechecking. Now it's Brian Glenn. Stopped by Kovalov in center. He's bumped by Glenn. Lafayette works it ahead. Lidster stops Kortnall, and Wells takes the puck. Fired across and out of the zone. Linden has to clear out. The next trying to get onside. Linden doing some punching and shoving with Larmer. Lidster gets to the red line. It's knocked down by Jeff Brown, picked up by Graves. Graves looks. He's passing off the skate of Hedekin. Out comes Murray Craven. Pass behind Foray, sent away by Zuboff. Glenn Anderson. He's stopped by Adams, trying to hit Foray. Zuboff gets it to Messier with 3:35 to go in the second. McClain leaves it for Brown. Around the boards, Leach has it. Past Anderson. Hedekin checked by Messier. Graves along the board.
Messier got a hooking call. This is a chance for Vancouver to get back in the game regarding the score. Messier reached out and with a little tug pulled down one of the Canuck players. And now a very important 2 minutes ahead for the Rangers. It's 3:21 on the clock. One of the better penalty killers, the best faceoff man for the Rangers, goes to the box. How much of a tug? Watch this.
Helped out by Hedekin.
Oh yeah.
He helped it out.
Absolutely.
Threw it nicely. He made the play he had to make. Messier shaking his head. Hooking at 16:39 gives Vancouver their first power play of the game. They are only 2-for-33 in the series. Jeff Kukubom set for his first shift since coming out of the locker room.
Very interesting that he'll be used to kill penalties and toughness in front of the net. Now he goes back off. I don't think he can, Sam.
They tested it.
Now, Vancouver's power play. Linden has one goal, one assist. Brown has one goal, one assist on the two goals Vancouver has scored. And there you see Pat Quinn and Ron Smith trying to get their strategy together. Jeff Kukubom is just too sore. You know he'd try if he could. So Leach and Lidstrom now have to start the penalty kill.
Tikkanen, Larmer, Lidstrom, Leach for the Rangers. Linden, Ronning, Bure, Brown, and Courtnall for Vancouver. Bure is playing the right point. Jeff Brown with the puck. Courtnall sends in. Leach for the puck, drives it up the boards. Knocked down by Bure. Good play. Tikkanen trying to take it away from Linden. Crowd along the boards, Linden with a good effort to keep it in. Ronning pushes it ahead. Leach gets to the puck and he clears up the boards. Cleared by Tikkanen. 2:50 to go in the second. 3-1, Rangers leading it. Larmer on Bure. Ronning turns with a puck. Met by Tikkanen. Bure forced back by Tikkanen. Now it's Ronning. And the chant of defense goes up from the crowd as Tikkanen takes the puck. Linden was taken down by Leach. And Tikkanen waits and then clears.
Great shift by Tikkanen, Lidstrom, and Leach. And they now all change. Fresh bodies on the ice for the Rangers.
Graves, McTavish, Lowe, and Zuboff for the Rangers. Brown slides it to Greg Adams. Adams moves in, met by Zuboff. McTavish helps out. Momesso with a cross check on Graves, knocked him down. McTavish moves it around, Bure in to play it. Bure to Ronning, keeps it moving to Momesso. Adams chases after it. He was tugged down by Zuboff. Zuboff trying to work it loose. Adams plays it up the boards for Ronning. Back for Brown. Graves steps in and he clears. 30 seconds to go. The Vancouver power play. They have not had a shot on goal yet. Matteau hooking at Bure. Bure stayed on for the full power play. Matteau drives it down the ice, but it deflected into the Vancouver bench.
So the faceoff will be inside the Rangers zone. Bure has great stamina, but he has not been able to find a way to get quality scoring chances in this game. Again, he's had more shots than any other player in the playoffs. He had 19 shots in the last three games going into this one. Esa Tikkanen is starting to drive people nuts. Watch this on Jeff Brown. Watch where the sticks go. Look at Jeff Brown's stick through the legs. Tikkanen, now watch him talk to Brown. Think about a slash. Now he's trying to bait Brown. Then all of a sudden, a little tug, and there goes Brown's stick. That's Esa Tikkanen at his best. He'd drive anybody crazy.
19 seconds to go in Messier's penalty. 1:41 to go in the second. Following the second, Al Trautwig with Emil Francis. Cat chat between periods. Bob Page with an update at the MSG Sports Desk. JD and I will look at highlights. Don't go away. A little work by Kevin Collins on the end of the stick. Craig McTavish. McTavish on the faceoff against Murray Craven. Craven, Momesso, and Adams, Babbage, and Lume. Bure has gone off. Lidstrom moves it up the boards. Lume keeps it in. Chased by Lidstrom. Momesso is there to play it. Now Craven moves it behind the net. Adams wrap around. Try saved by Richter. In the corner it goes, and Larmer clears all the way down. Power play is over for Vancouver. Teams at full strength. Rangers lead 3-1 with a minute 15 to go in the second. Lidster's got the puck. Messier chasing against Didick. Messier with a hit, trying to get loose to take it away. He's hit, and Kovalov hits back. Puck moved out by Babbage. Craven dumps it ahead. Less than a minute to go in the second period. Momesso on low. Zuboff takes a hard hit from Antoski. Matteau gets it to Messier. Kovalov racing forward. Kovalov is in. The backhander's wide. Kovalov chases down against McIntyre. Puck loose. Leach steps up to keep it in the zone. Hunter gets it ahead of Antoski. Antoski sends it in. Leach back to the puck. 30 seconds to go in the period. Each team with a goal here in the second. Take it away. Nice setup for Courtnall. Save Richter. Quinn couldn't play it. McTavish has the puck. 20 seconds in the period. McTavish controls. McLean holds the puck. Courtnall pressed by Noonan. Hunter winds up, deflected into the corner. Final seconds of the second period. Standing ovation. The Rangers are 20 minutes away.
Vancouver does what they do best. Towards the end of the period, they use the body. They try to punish the Rangers. Remember, they don't have Bukaboom on the blue line. Rangers' penalty killing was fabulous, and they needed that. Alexei Kovalov with a hug from Kiprios. Alexei Kovalov has played the game of his life, as have many, many New York Rangers. They have the 3-1 lead, and now they have to just make sure they have composure during the intermission, because Vancouver, with their brilliance, watch them come back. They'll try.
And we are set for the third period. This most dramatic moment approaching as the Rangers take a 3-1 lead into this third period of Game 7.
Mike Keenan, prior to the game, said he wanted his team to work as a team with confidence and enthusiasm like they have all season long. Well, he's certainly seen that. And to this point, Pavel Bure has only had one shot on goal through two periods. The big boys are back on the ice to start the period for Vancouver, and they may really try to be enthusiastic with their body work.
No Jeff Bukaboom. He has not returned to the ice. So the Rangers will be without him for this third period. Messier, Anderson, and Graves. Leach and Lidstra for the Rangers. McLean leaves it for Babbitt. Around the boards, Tim Hunter. Hunter, McIntyre, and Antoski for Vancouver. Lidstra ridden hard by Antoski. Leach moves it. Graves is hit by Diddick. And Vancouver coming out, banging.
You knew it was going to happen.
Fired across the boards. Anderson brings it out. Anderson chased by Antoski. Anderson moves in. One hands it in front. Tipped wide by Graves. Around the boards. Hunter moves it out of the zone.
Right, Dougie Lidstra ever get nailed by Antoski. Appears to be all right, but Vancouver wanted that on the first shift. It's like going after a wounded animal. Without Bukaboom, the Rangers are hurting on the blue line, and Vancouver tries to take advantage of it.
Bure is wrapped up by Matteau as the Rangers press. Larmer sneaks free with a puck, then Hedekin steps in front of him to take it. He's forced back by Matteau. 1 minute gone by in the third. Matteau checked by, Hedekin checked by Larmer, knocked it away, and it's kept in by Kovalov. Matteau races to the puck, sets up Larmer, was tipped. Great play by Jeff Brown, diving across. Back the other way, it's shot in by Adams, by Greg Adams. Zubov takes over, moves away with the puck. Two players went down, Adams and Lowe. Deep in the Rangers zone. Jirke Lume fires ahead, wide of the net. After the puck comes Glenn, it's knocked away from him. Kovalov has it. Leach trying to keep it moving. Brian Glenn goes over to play it. In deep, Greg Adams. Blocked by Glenn, who knocks it away. It's kept in by Trevor Linden. His shot into the chest of Richter. He drops it off for Leach. Linden forechecking, off the boards, out of the zone. Nice play by Kovalov, who pushed it ahead. Lume is bumped by Noonan. 2 minutes gone by in the third period. Jeff Courtnall is chased by Craig McTavish. Stopped by Tikkanen. It's slid across. Leach goes over to play it. Diddick on him. McTavish sends in from the red line. Rangers holding a 3-1 lead as David Babbage moves up. Lead for Lafayette is too long. This will be an icing. The fans love it at the Garden. The Rangers have a 2-goal lead. Anthony Mason, he's a Ranger fan. 17:35 to go. Thanks, Al. Good luck to Anthony Mason and the Knicks tomorrow night. Jay Wells shoots. Save made by Kirk McLean. Backhands it up the board. Wells pinching in. Linden tried to take it away. McTavish goes for the puck. McTavish to Noonan. Noonan cuts in. Noonan shoots. Save McLean. The rebound loose. Noonan tied up. And the puck cleared aside. Lidstra chips it ahead. Once again, this line of McTavish and Noonan. And Tikkanen doing an excellent job of keeping Vancouver pinned. Here's Noonan to the net. Kochek away. And it's stopped by McLean on the goal line.
A brilliant shift. And the Rangers again needed something like that. McTavish now wrestled from behind by Gerald Dittick. Brian Noonan and Stephane Matteau and Craig McTavish, amongst others, have really risen for this game. At times, you wondered, was Brian Noonan hurt worse than we thought? He had a subluxed shoulder during the Devils series. He had a bad leg. And look at Kirk McLean with a goal stick, make the save, and then find a way. Oh, baby. He reaches back and captures the puck. Smart save. Noonan was actually in too deep here. He's reaching. He's at the end of a shift. And the aggressive goal stick by McLean keeps the puck away. Look at Brian Noonan make the move outside, inside of Gerald Dittick. And then he'll go to try and find the rebound, but he can't get there. Dave Babich's big feet are in the way. And Noonan goes to the bench after a terrific shift.
I like those medical terms you use, John. Subluxed shoulder, that's good. You've been learning the medical stuff.
Call it game, man.
You're not nervous, are you? Zubov moving with a puck. Knocked away by Zelina. Here's Graves. Bumped by Mamesso. Graves moving in deep. He's checked by Hedekin. Now Messier. Stopped by McLean. Zelina for Mamesso. 16:45 to go in the third period. Zelina in the corner against Zubov. Anderson trying to find the puck. Zelina moves it. Side of the net. There's Kevin Lowe. Out to Messier. Messier dumps it in. 3.5 minutes gone by in the third. Rangers leading 3-1. Jeff Brown. Hedekin fires out. Good play by Lidster. Again, Lidster stepped up. Kovalov tipping it ahead. Got knocked down by Zelina. The puck cleared out of the zone. Kovalov is there to play it. Pushed his way by Ronning and sent it into Vancouver zone. 4 minutes gone by in the third. Lidster stops it, sends it in. Rangers get onside, go for a change. Jeff Brown has the puck. Adams trips it ahead. Here's Bury breaking in. He's pulled down and a penalty called on Tinkinen.
He's like a shark, an absolute shark. And now all of a sudden it gets quiet in Madison Square Garden. The shark is Bury. He was in, he was home free, and Tinkinen reached out, pulled him down. It turned that a good penalty, I think. Going, it was Bory on the puck, and he was in home free. You see the puck get chipped ahead by Greg Adams, and Tinkinen has trouble with it. Now, Bory would have been in from the top of the circle on Mike Richter, who was caught moving out, I think. Maybe not set. Oh, he was set. Anyway, Bory was dragged down. It's a very, very, very important 2 minutes ahead for both teams. There's the shark. He's only had one shot. Tried to get a second and was dragged down.
Tinkinen for hooking at 4:16. Gets the Canucks their second power play of the game. They are 0-for-1.
Even though Tinkinen's a penalty killer, the Rangers use 9 different forwards to kill penalties. So they've got plenty of reserve in that area.
Jeff Kukabum has returned to the Rangers bench. Tandem defense goes up. Messier won the draw. Leach with the clear. Canucks with Brown and Bure at the points. Cortnall, Linden, and Ronning up front to see Jeff Brown with the puck. Around the boards. Leach and Lidster with Messier and Graves for the Rangers. Messier and Leach are there. Leach trying to lift it clear. Taken away by Ronning. Ronning around the net. Ronning back pass. Brown couldn't tee up a shot. Ronning to Cortnall. He shot it. They score! As it was batted in by Trevor Linden.
That's a beautiful goal. Lars, passwork, and power play goals go. This was an absolute beauty. Now it's 3-2.
It's a one-goal game again. The Canucks have been down by 2 twice.
The Canucks have 4 players on that side, only 2 Rangers, and they control the puck. Now you're going to see 2 great passes. This one and this one. And then Trevor Linden gets his second goal, his second specialty team's goal of the game. Linden's in front, he'll get open, and Mike Richter, he just can't get across. He tried desperately, and Linden shot the puck quickly and accurately. Hang on.
Had to expect Cortnall to shoot. A brilliant pass by Jeff Cortnall. Linden's second of the game. A shorthanded goal, a power play goal, and it's a 3-2 game with 15:05 to go in the third period. Rangers are offside on the play. 50. 15:01 on the clock. Linden gets the goal, his 12th of the playoffs, from Courtnall and Ronning at 4:50 to cut the Rangers' lead to 1. The Canucks, they continue to come back. What heart they've shown throughout the playoffs. They did it against Calgary. They've done it in this series, and they continue to fight back against the Rangers, down by 2 goals twice. They are back within 1. Courtnall in center. Lead for Nathan Lafayette, moving in on Zuboff. He shoots, save Richter, and McTavish got to the rebound. Another big save by Mike Richter. Tekin in the other way. Drops it off for Zuboff. Zuboff moves in deep. Around to McTavish. He's double-teamed. Noonan in the corner. Tries to get it to McTavish. He's hit by Brian Glenn. McTavish keeps it alive. Tekin in looking for it. And a whistle stops play. 14:21 to go.
Trevor Linden with a second goal here in the third period. He scored the majority of his goals in third periods this season. So he gets a big one. However, it was Lafayette, one-on-one, goes to the outside of Zuboff and gets a good shot. He caught Richter moving, and that's why Richter went down on the original shot. He was moving and off balance. See him moving to his left? Now he kicks out the right foot, and McTavish kicked out his right foot to drag the puck away, so the rebound wasn't there for a Canuck player to dart in.
Shots are 30-24 in favor of the Rangers, who lead 3-2. Leach, Graves, and Messier, the goal scorers for the Rangers. Linden with 2 for Vancouver. Messier, Graves, and Anderson with Lidster and Leach. And Obukaboom has returned to the bench. He's not returned to the ice. Leach shoots through a crowd and was tipped wide. McLean never saw it. Never moved. Lifted clear by Adams. Anderson, though, kept it in on the line. McLean leaves it for Gerald Dittick. Off the boards for Adams.
Rangers need that forechecking game again to keep Vancouver off balance, to keep Vancouver's defense from joining the rush, and maybe draw another penalty.
Messier moving in, bumps with Dittick, the puck is loose, so is a glove. Babich has it, moves it ahead for Adams, up the middle of Craven, Leach is back, 2-on-1, Leach intercepts, as Jelena was cutting in, Graves the other way, he's bumped along the boards by Adams, puck taken back by Babich, gets it to Craven. Craven shoots, deflected wide, went off a skate, Jelena just missed the rebound. Anderson moves it out to Graves. Graves dumps in. 13:25 to go in the third. Rangers leading 3-2. But the Canucks are putting the pressure on. Lining the Brown. Lomesso is bumped by Lowe. Zuboff has the puck. Ronning on him. Off the boards, Hennigan. Ronning's got it. Laid it across. Matteau takes over and sends it in. In the corner, Larmer and Hedekin. Larmer got knocked down by Brett Hedekin. Ronning couldn't play it. Larmer gets up, trying to work it loose. Then a whistle stops play. 12:53 to go in the third.
Stefan Matteau has really had a great game. It's the best he skated in a while. I don't know how he skates or what he skates on. He's got a pair of skates that are a couple of years old, and if you look at the toes, the training staff led by Mike Volga, he has done everything to try it. Look at the black stuff on the bottom underneath the toes of his feet there. He has tried to work these blades to get one more game out of them. And this will be the last game that those skates will ever see, believe me. He has been good. He's been aggressive. He skated well. He's read plays. And this is tight. Oh.
Fans rising to their feet at the Garden in a Let's Go Rangers chant. Rangers have done well on the faceoffs. McTavish on with Tekin and Noonan, Zuboff and Wells. Linden with Courtnall and Lafayette. Lume and Glenn. Linden wins it in the corner. Jerky Lume plays the puck. Lume off the boards. Wells sends it back. McTavish trying to gain control. Knocked away from him. Courtnall looks it to Lafayette. Back for Linden. Linden moving in is checked by Noonan. Linden got the shot off and Richter stops it.
It looked like Richter's stick may have been off the ice a little bit and he just caught the top portion of the puck. Trevor Linden uses his body so well to shield the opposition player to find a way to get the shot. Let's watch as the Rangers turn the puck over in the neutral zone. Watch. See the lean there by Linden? Now you get the shot. Look at Richter's stick. He got the save. That's what he needed. Linden with a good job keeping his balance. Again, see the shot go through. Richter hangs on, another defensive drive.
Linden really playing a strong game seven for Vancouver.
He uses his body so well, again, to shield the opposition.
Messier, a good win on the faceoff. Lidstrom able to move it to Anderson. He gets clear. Messier picks it up and moves across. Messier to Graves. Graves shoots wide. Around the boards, Lidstrom is there. He winds up, his shot blocked in front. Cleared by Lume to Linden. Linden moving in on Brian Leach. Leach takes him out with the hip check. Lidstrom gets to the puck, is bumped by Lafayette. And Linden moves in with a hit. Lidstrom still has the puck and comes away with it. Off the boards and out of the zone. Just under 12 minutes to go. As the Rangers take an icing, 11:53 on the clock. Brian Leach with the big hit. Along the boards, taking out Trevor Linden on the rush.
Leach will love to use the hip check if he has the player to the outside. And that's a good play to take the man out. You have to make sure you take the body, because if you miss, you take yourself out of the play. The stamina, so important now for Brian Leach, as he's played a lot. Glenn Healy, who's got the best seat in the house, really acting as a great cheerleader for his teammates.
Al Trotwig is at ice side. What do you see, Al?
Well, Sam, what I see is a very, very tired Doug Lidstrom. You know, Puka Boom's not out there. And like the third period of Game 5, the Rangers defensemen are getting an awful lot of pressure. It's been showing, at least to me, on his face in a big way.
McTavish wins the faceoff from Ronning. The puck rolls out of the zone. Around the boards, past Richter. Zuboff is there. It trickles out of the zone. It's picked up by McTavish. A hit for Noonan. Noonan on Dittick. McTavish to the net. Noonan trying to get by Dittick, who blocked it. McTavish slides it out of the zone. Zuboff moves it back. Ronning trying to hit Bure. Lowe's got the puck. It's Bure with Lomesso and Ronning now. Pekkanen takes a long pass and dumps it ahead. Got hit by Dittick.
Bure getting double shifted in place of Zelina. Bure, the better scorer.
Leach sends it back to the Vancouver zone. Picked up by Babich. Rangers leading 3-2. As Babich fires ahead, Larmer knocks it away from Craven. Brought in by Kovalov with 11 minutes to go. Kovalov toward the net. And sliding into the net went Steve Larmer. Kovalov upset as he was hit in the corner by Dittick.
Last couple of shifts. Vancouver's tried to break the game, and the Rangers have fought back. Larmer goes to the net. You can see he just simply hauled down by Pavel Bure. No penalty. Again, good play by McLean to avoid Steve Larmer. Kovalov tried to put the puck in front. It was blocked. As the whistle sounds, he got thumped. He got thumped in the corner by Gerald Dittick, who's played a tough game.
10:56 to go. Brian Leach, 27 shifts, almost 27 minutes of ice time. Brett Hedekin sends it ahead. Greg Adams moves in, and Lidstrom steps up with a fine defensive play. Zelina after the puck. Lidstrom's tackle, and a whistle stops play as Lidstrom's on top of the puck. Greg Adams hauled him down. 10:43 to go. Third period. Rangers leading 3-2. 3-2 Rangers, 10:43 to go in the third. Craven and Messier for the faceoff. Craven with Adams and Zelina, as Pat Quinn is taking up the lines a little bit. Change things up.
Well, to take Bure away from Craven is quite interesting.
Put Ronning with him.
Well, Ronning, he must say, has been a better playmaker than any of his other centermen in this game.
Oh, a tough bouncer that Richter offside. Went down. It was an offside.
It was an offside, but I'll tell you what. The infield didn't look too good on that play, did it? Messier's 12-6 on faceoffs. Watch this thing. The puck skips. The flex skips. Richter played it well. It was a difficult play. A little deflection right there off Kevin Lowe, and the puck is fluttering and bouncing.
Wow.
Time isn't moving very quickly, is it right now?
Not for Ranger fans. 10:25 to go as Kovalov wins the faceoff. Zuboff has the puck. Now Kevin Lowe lifts it toward the Vancouver zone. Hedekin stops the puck. Right back out. Lowe chases back. Now Jeff Brown. Controlled by Craven. He sends into the Rangers' zone. Midway point of the third period. Rangers leading 3-2. Adams moves it. Craven wrapped up by Lowe. Zuboff trying to get away. Fired out. Here's Kovalov with ground back. Kovalov holds up. Look, feed alarmer. Save McClain. Matteau is hit. Matteau keeps the puck alive in the corner. Kovalov moves in. Hedekin checking in. Matteau tries to work it loose. Kovalov's got it along the board. Took a hard hit by Craven. Puck behind the net. Jeff Brown moves out with it. 9.5 minutes to go. And once again, Vancouver had too many men on the ice in a sloppy change.
They're not going to call it, Sam, in this situation.
And they call against Boston and Don Cherry. Here's a puck knocked away. Here's McTavish to Noonan. Noonan to Leach. Across to Lindstrom for the shot blocked by Lafayette. Peeking it along the board, but a whistle stops play.
And not
Terry
exactly
Gregson
sure.
Talking with Craig McTavish here.
Well, Gregson, he seems to be calling penalties, maybe one to each player.
Yeah. McTavish and Linden.
Rangers, I think, would love to take that trade off. Linden has 2 goals in the game, and maybe has been the best forward for Vancouver. Craig McTavish has played well, but the Rangers have the lead.
A real winner knows how to party right. Please, use good sense when you drink. Know when to say when. A reminder from Budweiser. 9:05 to go in the third. Rangers leading 3-2. And let's see.
There's Vancouver. Counting the goaltender, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players, and you'll see someone come off the bench. Again, 5 skaters. And there's the extra, and it did hit the foot. Look at the hands of the linesman in the background waving. No, nothing.
That was Kevin Collins.
I don't think you'll see anything cheap like that called in this situation. At least I hope not.
They'll skate 4 aside for 2 minutes. Linden and McTavish, 2 minutes each for roughing at 10:55. And as you mentioned, John, Pat Quinn upset with the call because he loses Trevor Linden, who probably has been his best player tonight.
I think that's without a doubt. Rangers seem to be delaying their changes here, Sam, and I think the reason is they're trying to rest their defense. Each change, Vancouver's had their players waiting for the faceoff, and the Rangers have been very deliberate. And there's no doubt that without Pukaboom, some of the players are getting a lot more ice time, and they need the break.
Lowe takes the shot. Hit the post! Lindstrom swings it around. That could have been the one. Kevin Lowe came oh so close. Lafayette played it ahead. Lindstrom back for it. Lowe and Lindstrom with Messier and Braves on a 4-on-4. Messier had to go off his stick. Lume with Glynn, Courtnall, and Craven. Lowe all over Courtnall. Forces the turnover. Graves has the puck. Now Messier. 8:35 to go in the third. Rangers leading 3-2. Vancouver a goal here in the third. Cut into the Rangers' 2-goal lead. Messier and Graves. Messier to Graves. He shoots and it's blocked by Babbitt. Courtnall has the puck. Met by Messier who knocked it away. Once again, Vancouver changes.
Their changes have been awful.
Oh, yeah.
They might get caught the way they're changing.
Leach. Nice pass to Tikkanen. He moves in on Hedekin. Lost control. Swings by Hedekin. In deep is Larmer. Larmer gets to the puck. Wraps it around right through the crease. Just under 8 minutes to go. A glove goes flying in the air. It's Tikkanen's glove. Hedekin has the puck. He's forced back by Larmer. Larmer was tripped up. Hedekin out for Bure. Bure gets by Leach. Moves in on Zuboff. Hook checked away by Zuboff. Good play by Sergei Zuboff. Pressured from Bure. Tikkanen trying to control. He's hit by Bure. Tikkanen moving with a puck. Tikkanen comes out of the zone, feeds Leach. Leach moving in on Jeff Brown. He shoots, save McClain. 15 seconds left in a 4-on-4. Brown moves out with a puck for Vancouver. 3-2 Rangers leading it. Brown shoots, save by Richter. Tough low shot by Jeff Brown. Noonan playing it across and Matteau gets to it. Matteau picked up by Ronnie. Keith back at full strength on the ice. 7 minutes to go in the third. Up the boards, it's blocked by Matteau. Matteau looking to make a pass. Matteau around the net. He's looking. He sees Noonan. Save made by McClain. Out comes Jelena. Lowe is back. Jelena with Linden and Ronning. Pass to Ronning. Now to Jelena. Hit the post. And it's cleared by Lowe. Oh man, Vancouver came out so close to tying it.
Both teams close to scoring. Kirk McLean with a big save. As Brian Noonan had the shot on the Matos setup. And then Vancouver on the rush just hit the outside of the goalpost. Mike Richter even lost his glove on the play. Kirk McLean quietly stands there. Look how quietly he stands on this play. Noonan releases to the right side. Shot. The puck didn't get through. Now look at this. It's a 3-on-2. Ronnie gives the puck back. The shot. Oh, was that close? And then was it close again? As Lowe fired the puck away. Kevin Lowe hit the goalpost. This was earlier. It's still 3-2. There's 6:36 to go.
Now, John, you saw Richter reach out and his glove went off.
Did he throw his glove?
Did he?
I don't know.
And if it had hit the puck, what would that have been?
Oh, maybe a penalty shot. It doesn't matter now.
No, 6:36 to go as Messier faces off with Linden and wins. And Lowe plays to Zubov. His pass blocked, but he chips it out. Back for the puck comes Gerald Dinner. 3-2 Rangers with 6:25 to go in the third. Messier in after the puck. Messier hit from behind by Dinnick. Back into the Vancouver zone it goes. Babich has the puck. Up the boards with Jeff Courtnall. Now to Trevor Linden. Back to Courtnall. Zuboff is there. The shot saved Richter. Courtnall centers. Saved by Richter! Lafayette had a chance. I thought he got the glove on it. It might have hit the post.
If he stopped it, it's a save of anybody's career.
Back in. Lowe's got the puck. 5:45 to go. Vancouver pressing for the tie. The Rangers sending it down. Intercepted by Kovalov. Can't get a shot off as he's knocked down by Hennigan. The puck taken by Larmer. Larmer shoots high. Off the glass around the Lidster. Lidster sending it to Matteau. Matteau waiting. Toward the net, Larmer's knocked down in the crease. Where's the puck? Kovalov's got it. Puts it in the crease, it's blocked. Out comes Bore. And a whistle behind the play, the net is knocked off. What a wild sequence. 5:18 to go in the third. Gregson says the faceoff is outside. We'll step out for a moment. It was a fabulous try by Mike Richter, but he got help from the post.
Each team has had a goal post in this third period. Lafayette, he beat Richter, but he didn't put the puck on the inside of the goal post and hit the outside and stayed out. Oh, is that close? Very close, and you can see then Lafayette was cleared out of the goal crease.
Actually, Vancouver's hit the post twice. Jelena hit the post earlier.
Yeah, I thought that was the outside of the post, but it was still close. Vancouver's resilient and they're showing it. The Rangers love the timeouts and they love each stoppage. They're trying to take as much time as possible to rest their defensemen.
Lonning with Bore and Momesso for Vancouver. Brown and Hedekin. Rangers have McTavish, Noonan and Tikkanen with Leach and Lidster. Rangers without Jeff Bukaboom, who suffered a leg injury. No icing, Lidster going back, Momesso hooking him. Lidster tries to move away, got tripped up by Momesso, and it's intercepted by Lidster coming back on the pass by Ronnie. McTavish moving in, McTavish on Hennigan. McTavish looking, around the boards to Noonan. Noonan holding along the board. Centers for Zuboff off his stick. Momesso checked by Tikkanen, who wrestles him down, and Noonan sends it in. 4:25 to go. Red Hedekin out to Yerke Lume. Graves knocks it down. Taken back by Vancouver's Brian Glenn. Across the line, Craven. To the puck, Jelena overskated. Anderson trying to clear. Lowe trying to clear. They get it out of the zone. Taken back by Lume. Into the corner. Leach goes for the puck. Leach takes a hit but moves the puck. Rangers clear the zone.
Vancouver with a lot of very slow, deliberate dump-ins. And then they're punishing, trying to create turnovers. And the Rangers are called for icing. This will be another slow change, I would think, by the Rangers. As Mike Keenan looks on, I don't think he was happy with the icing call. However, it is. And it's a defensive drive. Vancouver, when they've shot the puck in, they're shooting it softly into the corners. And they're just trying to put it and regain control of the puck.
3:52 remaining in the third period. Rangers leading 3-2.
The Rangers with a slow change again. Taking every opportunity to buy time, buy time. McTavish will be out for the draw. I guess Murray Craven is good on the draw. Mike Keenan barks. Neil Smith and Larry Blow. They feel it.
Craven with Jelinek Adams. McTavish with Tikkanen and Noonan. Slides to the boards. Leach goes to the puck and lifts it out. And back for it comes Gerald Dittock. Forechecking is Noonan. Up the boards. Tikkanen couldn't play it. Jelinek sends it ahead. He's upended by Tikkanen. Leach to Zubov. Zubov pulls back. Plays it off the boards and out of the zone. Dittock sends it in. 3:25 to go. Leach double teams. And he is hit along the boards, but he moves the puck to Tikkanen. Now to Sergei Zubov. Zubov across. Stick handles in. McLean clears it aside. Kevin Lowe comes on and drives it back into the Vancouver zone. 3:10 to go. Gerald Dittock looks up. Matto forechecking. Marner is on. Kovalov's on. Off the board. Blocked by Kovalov. Matto is checked along the boards by Babich. Kovalov reaching for the puck. Canucks bring it out. Jeff Courtnall sends it in. Lowe got a piece of it with a glove. Lidstrom plays it. 2:48 to go. Off the boards for Kovalov to Matto. Here's Kovalov to two-line pass.
Faceoff will go back inside the Rangers zone once again. 2:44 to go. Pavel Bure should be well rested. Mike Richter gets another water bottle. As he tries to put fluid back in his system. The teams have their timeouts remaining. Ranger fans are standing. Vancouver fans are hoping. And we have 2:44 to go in the third period.
They're on their feet, fans of all ages.
They might be on their feet in their homes and their apartments and wherever they're watching.
Ernie Grunfeld of the Knicks in attendance. Ranger fans alive as the Rangers.
The big boys.
3-2.
The big boys. Bure, Linden, Courtnell, Brown, Hennigan. It's all offense right now for Vancouver.
And it's Messier, Graves, Anderson, Leach, and Lidstrom for the Rangers. As the Rangers set the defense. Leach is looking at Bure.
Faceoffs are a five-man responsibility.
Richter steers to Lidstrom. Moves it up the boards for Graves. Out of the zone, Messier after it. Courtnall gets there. Gets it back to Linden. 2.5 minutes to go. Hennigan moves in. Hennigan toward the net wide. Around the boards. Messier takes a hard hit from Linden. Graves gets to the puck. He's pressured. He lifts it. Clear out of the zone. Brown back to the puck. Anderson after him. 2:15 to go. The puck past Leach. Courtnall chops at Leach. Zubov. Cleared out by Zubov, taken back by Ronnie. Ronnie moves across, Zubov is there. Courtnall's pass was blocked. Courtnall, blocked by Leach, moves it to the boards. Graves chips it out of the zone. Sent back in, no, is kept in by Lume. Fans didn't like it. Leach, pressured by Bure, gave it up to Ronnie. Loose puck, Ronnie chips it back to Lume. Lume moving down the boards. Rangers can't gain control. Bure behind the net. Bure taken down by Zubov. And Zubov lifts it clear. And right now you can get away with anything. And that's why Zubov tripped up Bure. Might as well do it.
Brian Noonan didn't have a stick. The Rangers had chances to get the puck over the blue line and couldn't. So now you'll see timeouts used as the best players, the majority have been on the ice. Jeff Courtnell's at the Vancouver bench. He can hardly get over the boards. He's so tired. Brian Leach and Zubov have to be exhausted. But it's the hearts that are big. Oh! You see here, Ronning had the glorious chance, but the Rangers surrounded him. The puck is along the boards. Noonan's in front without a stick. Zubov trips his man up, and then he just ices the puck.
Canucks have called timeout. As you watch The puck sent down the ice for icing. 1:31 to go. Third period. Rangers 3, Canucks 2. Pat Quinn talking to his team. Don't forget, the Canucks came back in game one and tied that game with exactly 1 minute to go and won in overtime. The Rangers have given up leads late in the playoffs to New Jersey and Vancouver. It's a very tense time. Al is downstairs. Al, what's going on?
Well, Sam, I'm right by the glass. Behind me is pandemonium, but a very special moment. Neil Smith came down from his perch, made his way with police escort to watch the last 1:31 with his wife Katya. Meanwhile, the table to hold the Stanley Cup is behind me. The New York City police are moving into position, and Madison Square Garden is ready to count it down. It's wild down here.
Kirk McLean is still in goal. Thanks, Al. Kirk McLean is still in goal. There's 1:31 to go.
Okay. Will this crowd get a chance to celebrate? Defense is the chant. 1:31 on the clock.
Terry Gregson trying to stop the Canucks from making a late change. Pavel Bure is on the bench, but he could be the player to come on if the goaltender goes to the bench.
Lume and Babich, Craven, Jelena, and Adams for Vancouver. McTavish with Noonan and Kekkonen, Leach and Lidster for the Rangers. Ray Scapinello set to drop the puck between Craven and McTavish. Craven wins. Lume moves in with a puck. Lume to the net. Knocked away by a sliding Leach. Noonan tied up by Adams. Lidster is hit by Jelena. The puck in the corner comes loose, but Gregson blew the whistle, stopping play.
Murray Craven has taken every big offensive zone draw for the Canucks, and he won the last one clean. And did Brian Leach ever read the play? Oh, my. You'll see here, Lume move in. Now watch Brian Leach in front of Richter. Bang. He leads with a stick and knocks the puck aside. Now the Rangers have rested the Messier line, and he'll come on for the faceoff.
1:20 to go.
Vancouver going with their bigger players, Sam. If they can get to the front of the net, they'll create a big screen. Bigger players. There's no Ronning and Bure on the ice.
Messier with Graves and Larmer as Kekkonen goes off. Craven for the faceoff. McLean still in the net. Craven wins. Tap back to Lume. Toward the net. Knocked down by Messier. He moves it for Larmer. Larmer is stopped. Messier swings it around. Leach goes for it with a minute 10 to go. Lifts it out of the zone with 1:05 to go. Adams back to Lume. Lume has the puck with 1 minute to go in the third period. McLean heads to the bench. Extra man on for Vancouver. The puck cleared out. 55 seconds to go.
Vancouver's made a bad change. They haven't got the players in order.
Seven men on the ice. 45 seconds to go. Lume's got the puck. Shoots it in. Richter stops it. Zuboff plays it. Up into the crowd. 30. The clock still ticking off.
That'll
a couple of seconds.
They'll be checking it upstairs. They have a timekeeper with a stopwatch in the replay booth. The officials will be checking it. When the puck went in the stands, Momesso looked up immediately. I think you'll see 1 or 2 seconds put back on the clock. And Vancouver, when the goaltender went to the bench, had a horrific line change or player change, and they were all messed up. Pucks in the stands, and the clock kept ticking.
Well, the puck went up in the crowd, and again, Pat Quinn wants time put on the clock. To this point, it has not been put back on. It's 36.2 on the clock. Have to say this, at one point there may have been 7 or 8 Canucks on the ice.
Well, nobody knew who to jump on the ice, nobody knew who to go off the ice, and they lost 2 or 3 valuable seconds.
And now Terry Gregson has been called over to the official scorer's table, and I believe they are looking at the tape upstairs for time.
Oh, sure, they have people in place for this. They'll look at it, they'll make sure. And I believe at least 1 second will be put back on the clock. I may be wrong, but it certainly appeared as though the clock kept clicking, ticking away.
36, I think it may be close to 2 seconds, John, it ticked off.
Vancouver has the goaltender head to the bench. Look at over on the right side. Look at the players. They don't know who's coming on, who's going off.
There's 7 on there right now. 7 Canucks.
Nonetheless, faceoff is to the left side, the near side of Mike Richter. Murray Craven has won the last two faceoffs in the Rangers zone, but they were on the other side of the ice. 1.6 seconds have been added onto the clock.
37.8 remaining. Rangers leading 3-2.
Vancouver's already used their timeout. Here they're extending it a little bit. Pat Quinn's telling everybody to move up ice. Messier, 15-7 on draws in the game. That doesn't matter much now.
Rangers 3, Canucks 2. 37.8 seconds remaining. Kirk McLean taking a peek, hoping his team can find a way to score a goal to keep it tied, to tie the game. The Rangers trying to hold on to win the Stanley Cup for the first time in 54 years. And a false start on the faceoff, Linden and Messier.
That was Linden, Mimesso who jumped in, so Linden should be out of there.
Along the boards, Zubov fires it around the glass, it's out of the zone. Back to the puck goes Jeff Brown, 30 seconds to go.
Oh, that's a bad call.
Oh, they called it icing. The Rangers can't believe it.
That is a bad call in my estimation. That should have been waved off. Kevin Collins called it icing. But Jeff Brown, credit Jeff Brown. He slowed his skating down to make sure the puck went over the red line. The Rangers have to retain their composure. You'll see the puck get fired around and down the ice. Now watch the defenseman. Right in the view now. Watch him slow. Look at him. He stopped skating. Now the puck's over the red line. That should not have been icing. Look at him slow down.
28.2 seconds remaining. Once again, Messier and Craven.
Now this is the side where Craven won his last two faceoffs on that side of the ice.
Craven with Courtnall, Mimesso, Linden, Bure, and Brown. And Craven delaying with the stick, adjusting the glove. Now Craven steps in. Craven against Messier. Messier gets to the puck, moves it, it's blocked by Courtnall. In deep, bounces past Linden. Leach trying to play it. Mimesso centers, it was stopped by Zubov. Linden back pass, Bure shoots, blocked in front. Into the corner it goes. Courtnall hits Zubov for the pass. Zubov swings it around. Roiber clears the zone. That's it. 54 years of curses are over. No more 1940.
Yes.
The New York Rangers are going to win.
It's 1.1 seconds on the clock, and Kevin Collins, I can't believe he allowed this to be icing again. Damn, there's 1.1 seconds on the clock.
1.1.
I'd like to see
hold the celebration
again.
One more time.
Got to see the replay again. I mean, Pavel Bure stopped skating.
54 years of curses and jinxes. 54 years of heartache. The chant of we want the cup.
I concur with Mike Keenan. And Neil Smith hasn't won it yet. It's 1.1 seconds to go. Now Bure will go after the puck. Watch him stop skating. He stops.
No.
That should not be icing. I'm sorry. But it is. There's 1.1 seconds to go.
Mike Keenan on the top step. He is on the ledge. Every person in Madison Square Garden on their feet.
Murray Craven's the left-handed shot. He'll, I think, try to go to the net when the puck is dropped.
This is the moment they have waited for a lifetime.
A lot of toilet paper on the ice. They're waiting to have that all cleared up before the puck will be dropped. That allows both teams to set their strategy.
3-2 Rangers. They have put back 0.5 of a second, 1.6 on the clock. Now, John, if I'm the Rangers, I just dive on top of the puck.
Absolutely. Now, it looks like it may be Bure taking the face off. And he'll just try to drive it towards the goal, I would think.
1.6 seconds.
one man back, and that's Brown. Poirier's going to go ahead with quick hands. McTavish will have to nullify it.
Here it is. The waiting is over. The New York Rangers are the Stanley Cup champions. And this one will last a lifetime.
No more curses. This is unbelievable. These people have waited a long time. Fans, players, coaches. Unbelievable.
Let the celebration begin.
Fabulous teams. Vancouver lost, but hockey was a winner for the New York Rangers and their supporters. No more 1940. It's gone. Congratulations, Rangers.
The 1994 New York Rangers have done it. And for every Ranger that ever put on a uniform, they can stand with pride. What a moment. A moment that has never been known at Madison Square Garden.
And on behalf of the former Rangers, thank you, 1994 Rangers. This is something special. Oh, remember this. Enjoy it.
Messier, Keenan, Leach, Kovalov, the first Russians to win a Stanley Cup.
Mark Messier delivered, folks. Delivered.
Yes, he did. Joey Koser couldn't play tonight. He joins in the celebration. This is worth waiting for. Mike Keenan. His first year as coach of the New York Rangers, and he delivered. And what a sad finish for a proud team. The Vancouver Canucks showing guts, coming back from 3-1 down in the series and battling back in this game from a two-goal deficit twice.
The Rangers worked all season long. First game was September 11th in England, in London, England. They worked all season long to get home ice. And they had home ice for the seventh game. They had their fans. They had the extra day off. They lost Jeff Bookaboom, who gave it everything but couldn't come back. And they won it. This is really something special. Two great hockey teams, a wonderful sport, a great handshake. It just doesn't get any better.
It took 107 games. And the New York Rangers have become the Stanley Cup champions. And the chant of 1940 has gone up from the crowd.
I'd love to hear it one more time.
Last time. You will not hear this again. No more 1940. Pavel Bure, what a proud, proud player. What a great one. And there he is. The Messiah has delivered.
Celebrate, party, enjoy. This has been an incredible roller coaster ride that ended up on the very top of the roller coaster.
And now the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy to the MVP of the playoffs, and then the moment they've waited a lifetime for, the Stanley Cup.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand by for the official presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy and the Stanley Cup. Ladies and gentlemen, to present the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 1994 Stanley Cup Playoffs Most Valuable Player, Commissioner Gary Bettman.
The winner. The Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the Stanley Cup playoffs is Brian Leach.
the first American-born player to ever win the Conn Smythe Trophy, the sixth defenseman to ever be so honored.
He won the Rookie of the Year. He won the Norris Trophy as the most valuable defenseman, and now he's won the biggest of them all. The Conn Smythe winner,
Brian Leetch of the New York Rangers.
Just wait. You're going to see the most beautiful piece of silver, the most wonderful. The Holy Grail is coming out, folks. This is just an incredible piece. Bob Gutkowski, the president of the Madison Square Garden, Neil Smith, Mike Keenan. Oh, does that mean something? These people have worked so hard.
Ladies and gentlemen,
hang on.
The Stanley Cup!
Whether you're a fan 4 years old, 64 years old, 84 years old, no matter how long you've waited, this is something special.
Look at the hands. These guys have white gloves on carrying the Stanley Cup. That is precious. It's beautiful. And it's going to have the New York Rangers all over it.
Well, New York, after 54 years, your long wait is over. Congratulations to the Rangers and the Vancouver Canucks for a spectacular finals. Congratulations to Bob Gutkowski, Neil Smith, and Mike Keenan, the entire Ranger organization, and most importantly, the players. Captain Mark Messier, come get the Stanley Cup.
Tina Turner's song, Simply the Best, blaring on the loudspeaker. That's the song the Rangers listened to before the game.
He came to New York 3 years ago to deliver the Stanley Cup, and there it is.
He's looking up at his family right now saying, I can't believe it.
How sweet it is. Kevin Lowe, a great champion. And there's the great one, Brian Leetch.
Brian Leetch had his shoulder frozen 3 or 4 times in the New Jersey Devils series just so he could play.
Adam Graves, the second time he has held the cup. Jay Wells, 15 years. Oh, look at that. 15 years he's waited for that. Taking it. Another great veteran, Steve Larmer. Greg Gilbert, one of the veterans brought in. And now the Black Aces, Eddie Olczyk.
This team stayed together all season long. Look at Sergei Nemchinov. They know what it means. Alexei Kovalov, you should be proud of yourself the way you played in this game. A spectacular game.
There's the man. Yes, Mike Richter. Boy, did he deliver in the clutch.
They love their goalies in New York City, and Mike Richter is at the top.
Ryan Noonan, Stephen Matteau. Two players who came over to help solidify this team. Sergei Zubov, did he ever develop into a great one this year?
Joey Koser couldn't play due to injury. Jeff Bookaboom, and you hear the boo for Bookaboom. This team believes. Oh, do they believe? And always it tough. That is such a tough, tough trophy to win. You do anything to win. Did Dougie Lister have a game when he had to play?
Mike Hudson. What a special moment for these players. In
my mind, this is the hardest championship to win. And now the chant that will live a lifetime, 1994. Len Anderson once again. He may not be in the NHL next season. He wanted to go out with a Stanley Cup. Alexander Karpovtsev takes in on the festivities. Oh, and I just saw how he rolls. Mike Keenan. That looks like a New York Ranger coach to me. Well, he says he'd like to win it again. Yes, there's the headline. It is. There's millions of fans in New York City who just, they're all a part of this. The support over the years. Everyone's a part of it. Neil Smith, congratulations.
5 years of hard work in putting this team together, and finally it's arrived. Colin Campbell.
Dick Todd in his first year in the NHL. It's 36 inches long. It weighs 36 pounds.
Time for a team photo. SCA did this a lot with the Edmonton Oilers. Get the teammates over. It's impromptu. You put that beautiful piece of silver there. Hey, all right.
Marv Albert has waited 28 years for this.
And how about our buddy Sal Messina? He's been a fan since the 50s.
Man, he was a Ranger player.
That's right.
In the stands as a backup goalie. How much does it mean to him?
This is the greatest photo for a team sport that these players will ever have. Look at the faces. Here comes Mike. Just look at the faces. His scars, his cuts, his teeth missing. Every bit of it was worth it.
A long journey. The marathon. And the Rangers win it.